weeks to shore everything up ahead of the A-10 tournament next month. And today, the Rams find themselves out west in the 3-1-4, looking to do something they've never done in program history: win on the road in St. Louis. And veteran head coach Travis Ford has turned St. Louis into one of the more consistent mid-majors in America. But this year, the Billikens have gotten off to their worst start in A-10 play in the Ford era at 1-7. Now losers of their last five, the Billikens will look to turn things around and defend home court here in Dogtown. It's Fordham and St. Louis, live from Missouri, next on 90.7 FM. Hello to you and welcome inside Chaffetz Arena here in downtown St. Louis. It's Saturday afternoon hoops here on WFUV Sports, the St. Louis Billikens and your Fordham Rams, another pair of Jesuit institutions here in the Atlantic 10. Alongside Colin Loughran, I'm Miles Grossman, and Colin, we got a matchup between two desperate squads this afternoon. St. Louis has dropped their last five. They're hungry to get back on track here at home. And on the other side, Fordham has dropped four out of their last five. Colin, two physical squads, we might have a battle on our hands.
Miles, great to be with you as always, and I think you used the exact right word, desperate. Both of these squads have underperformed greatly in conference play. Both need a get-right win that could potentially get them back on the right path.
Absolutely, Colin. It's two teams looking for a bounce-back victory today. But before we get underway here from Missouri, we got to catch up with Keith Ergo, the head coach of Fordham men's basketball, to talk the Richmond loss, the rotation, and much, much more. Have a listen.
Coach, thanks so much for your time. Last time out, a tough loss against a really polished, talented Richmond team, and they got a bit more comfortable in the second half, went on a run and opened things up. Just a great shooting night from Richmond, but outside of that, what kind of led to that comfortable run in the second half?
Well, yeah, I mean, they're a confident group. They got a bunch of fifth-year seniors. They got a lot of guys who have been through losses and wins. They're playing so connected. They have great leadership. And you could see when we made our run and cut it to four in the second half, they didn't get rattled. They kind of got together. When we cut it to four, they got a stop. Then they got to the free throw line. Then they got another stop. Then they got to the free throw line. Then they got another stop. Then they scored, right? So they're a really older, more mature group at the moment. And you can see their connectivity, you know. And Coach Mooney's one of the best in the business. He's been there a long time. And I think King is player of the year right now, candidate. You know, I know Daron Holmes is special, and he's tremendous, and he's definitely at the top of that list, him and King. Mm-hmm. But, you know, they beat him head-to-head, and they're in first place. And, you know, he's playing at a level that he's very difficult to guard.
Coach, I can remember in October, November, you spoke about how this is a younger Fordham team. Can a loss like the one that you guys took against Richmond serve as a kind of learning experience for a group that is still kind of learning and feeling their own?
Every loss, every win is a learning experience. We watch film either way to try to get better. These guys are not hanging their heads. They're connected. There's no selfishness. There's a trust and a connectivity that we need to continue to build like every other team. And that's always the goal. Again, you've heard me say it multiple times, just to be the best team we can be by the end of the year.
And in terms of the rotation, we saw Jaffe and Abdu check on pretty early in that first half. And, of course, we know Jaffe is still maybe returning from the ankle a little bit, but Abdu moved to the second unit. Moving forward, should we expect to see those veterans as kind of the first two off the bench holding down that second unit?
Well, we'll see about tomorrow night. You know, it's funny. Antrell Charlton came to me and, you know, said, look, I think we need to do this or that. You know, Jaffe's really important. He's feeling better now. Maybe we could get him into a rhythm if he gets back into the starting lineup. And that just shows me the leadership that we need to move forward and become the best team we can be. To have a guy sacrifice and make that type of commitment and say some things like that bodes really well. But, you know, both of those are starters, in my opinion. Whether or not they start in the beginning or whether or not they finish the game or come off the bench, minutes don't really change. We need Abdu to get back to his rhythm. His knee's feeling better, which is important. We need Jaffe, who's feeling much better with his ankle. We just got to find that rhythm again.
As you mentioned, Jaffe Madur is still kind of returning from that ankle injury. He's so good in terms of his ability to facilitate and score and pick his spots when he needs to. How do you go about explaining to him that at certain points he may have to take the offensive load?
We've been talking about that a lot. He's, you know, he's got to, and he was getting to that point. You saw it at St. Bonaventure. You saw it moments throughout the year, but really St. Bonaventure, where he made it clear, okay, this is my ball. Put you on my back. I'm the go-to guy in certain moments. And he started the game off against Davidson that way. So he knows what he's capable of. This team believes in him, actually wants him to be that type of player. So we continue to tell him, you've got to look to score first and then set everybody up, because you put so much pressure on the defense when you're playing with a lot of confidence. So we got to get back to that.
Coach, thank you so much for your time and good luck.
Go Rams.
And back inside Chaffetz Arena here in St. Louis, Missouri, it's the Fordham Rams and the St. Louis Billikens. Those Fordham Rams, a couple changes to the starting lineups. Jafay Madore reinserted back into the starting lineups. And as you heard Keith Ergo say, at Antrell Charlton's request, he's been moved out of the starting lineup. Your starting five, Jafay Madore, Will Richardson, and Kyle Rose wraps up the backcourt. He makes his 130th appearance as a Fordham Ram. That's the all-time record, and it's only going to continue to grow. And then the tandem duo down low, the young guys Ramad Dean and Elijah Gray continue to get those starts. And on the other side for St. Louis here at home, some injuries. Michael Meadows, the senior guard out of Campbell Hall in Hollywood, is out with a back issue. So Sion Medley, the freshman guard out of Camden, New Jersey, gets the nod. He's coming off a career-high 11 points, and his running mate in the backcourt is Larry Hughes II, the local kid out of St. Louis, Missouri, the top three-point shooter on this team. And the big guys, Gibson Jimerson, in his fifth year here at St. Louis, only a redshirt junior for some odd reason, obviously the COVID year, et cetera, but he is a tall guard who can shoot the lights out. And then Terrence Hargrove, another player in his fifth year here at St. Louis, another East St. Louis local product, 18 points last time out versus Loyola Chicago. And then wrapping it up is the junior forward, the Oak Hill product, believe it or not, Bradley Ezeuero, the Power 5 pedigree, transferring over from first Georgetown, LSU, and now here a St. Louis Billiken. But Colin, two teams desperate for a win here in Missouri. So glad you could be here with me.
And St. Louis has a very talented roster. Obviously, the record is not wonderful on paper, but when you think about the types of players this team has, they are a group of grinders that can hurt you 10 ways to Sunday. They had a big comeback win earlier in this season here at Chaffetz Arena against the St. Joseph's Hawks. They came back from 20 points down. That was the largest comeback in the arena's history. So they're not going to go away quietly. Fordham has to get off to a good start and play clean basketball.
Elijah Gray in the center circle with Bradley Ezeuero. Fordham moving left to right in their road maroons. Ezeuero taps it back, and St. Louis will have the first possession of the day here at home. It's Sion Medley, the freshman guard, moving right to left. He'll hand off at the top of the key for the big Ezeuero. Here's Hughes at the top of the circle, looks for Jimerson, and it's tapped out of play by Kyle Rose on the near sideline. So possession stays right here with St. Louis. 15 seconds in, zeros on the scoreboard.
Very first possession, Slew trying to get the ball to Jimerson. He is the focal point of their offense. He can shoot from anywhere on the court, Miles.
The undersized point guard, the freshman Medley, top of the circle, angles his way to the right arc, draws two defenders, lobs the pass near side for Jimerson. He's got it right arc up top for Hargrove. Hargrove, top of the key, three, and he's got it. St. Louis on the board first, 3-0 here at home.
Hargrove with a clean look. He's a 39% shooter from range. He spreads the floor nicely, gives you a different look offensively each time depending on what his MO is.
Madore bursts of speed, gets in the lane and down the lane with the lefty lay. And gets Fordham right back on the board. It's 3-2, St. Louis with the basketball.
And you know Fordham fans want to see a lot more of that. Coach Ergo talked to us about how Jafay Madore knows he has to be a shoot-first player at times.
Jimerson on the Slew logo, looks for Hughes. Ramad Dean posts free the pass, and it's into the hands of Jafay Madore. Madore and the Road Maroons moving left to right into the offensive half. Here's Kyle Rose, top of the key, three. No good off the left side of the iron, and Hughes pulls down the weak side rebound for Slew. They got the basketball into the offensive half. Here's under the basket. It's Ezeuero and the transition deuce off the left side of the window. A 5-2 start for St. Louis here at home.
And that looked like a football play in the end zone, Miles. Ezeuero just leaped up for it and put home the basket.
Ramad Dean catches the lob under the basket, rises from the right block and gets it to go. Off the window and down, and Fordham back within one. It's 5-4, 90 seconds in here from Missouri.
Both teams playing some fluid offense to start this game. Nothing rigid about what we're seeing so far.
Here's the freshman point guard, Sion Medley, skips it in the hands of Larry Hughes. Larry Hughes the second, near side forecourt. Right hand dribble, knee high, he'll pull the triple, no good. Well short off the right side of the iron, and Will Richardson the free rebound. Now moving left to right for the Fordham Rams. Jimerson switches onto him, he finds Gray. Top of the key, three, and he's got it. Elijah Gray nails it, and a 7-5 start for the Rams.
Very intelligent pass from Will Richardson that time. He had Jimerson on him. That's not a matchup he's going to win at his size. Smart to find the outlet and find Gray wide open for a three.
Deion Medley, freshman point guard, skip past left corner Hughes. Left corner three, no good on the answer. Short off the left side of the iron, and Elijah Gray, the rebound ahead to Will Richardson. Richardson left elbow, he'll float it down low for Gray. Gray rises and he draws the contact. Two free throws coming for the sophomore Elijah Gray, who's making his fourth career start today. And Colin, Elijah Gray has been a major bright spot for the Fordham Rams as of late.
And it's worth wondering where this Fordham team would be without him. That time on this possession, did a nice job of working his way towards the paint. The Rams realize they have St. Louis just a little bit off kilter to start this one, trying to use all the momentum they can get.
So Fordham gets their leading free throw shooter to the line early, the 78.7%er. One dribble with the right hand. And the high arcing free throw is well short off the front of the iron. So the Fordham lead holds it just two. It's 7-5 Rams here on the road, facing a pretty filled out Chaffetz Arena here in St. Louis, Colin.
Absolutely, Miles. Such a great sports city, St. Louis. Not typically known for their basketball, but the SLU fans have certainly shown up today.
So Elijah Gray, one more from the free throw line, and he rattles this one home. So the Fordham lead up to 8-5 now. 17:30 to play first half. Here's Hughes. Swings at high post for the freshman point guard in Medley, and he gets slammed on the floor. And we'll see. Looks like this one's on Elijah Gray, and that one was careless, so he will get subbed out immediately. Abdu Simbila on, Elijah Gray off here with 17:25 to play in our first half. It's 8-5, the Fordham Rams lead St. Louis basketball.
And that's how Fordham is going to have to play against Medley specifically. He has a team-high 66 assists for the Bills this year, and he doesn't want to shoot the ball necessarily. He wants to find the open man.
Medley draws two, drops it down low, and rising is Ezeuero, but he's blocked. A great defensive stand for Simbila and Co. Going ahead is Jafe Madur. Up top, Ramad Dean. Top of the key, three, no good. Off the front of the iron, but Abdu pokes it free into the hands of Jimerson. And now Gibson Jimerson. Moving right to left, he finds his point guard. Medley pulls up on the 10-foot floater, well short. And Abdu, the rebound, now moving left to right. He finds Jafe Madur on the outlet pass. 8-5 for him up top. Will Richardson transition triple, no good off the left side of the iron, and no one can corral the rebound. Out of bounds on the offensive baseline of Fordham, but they'll say last touch. Ramad Dean and Co. going back St. Louis's way. It's 8-5 Fordham, 16:50 to play, first half.
And Antrell Charlton checking in for Fordham now. Will Richardson coming out, so it will be Charlton along with Kyle Rose. No Madur at the moment. Whenever that happens, you know Charlton will be facilitating. Oh, Madur is there. So it looks like we'll have to see who will run point for the Fordham offense.
So Medley, a burst of speed into the offensive half, near side fourth court of St. Louis now. Medley angles to the right perimeter. Josh Rivera switches onto him. Medley, right side mid post, looks to damp it down low. He finds Ezeuero. Ezeuero rises from the right block, and he's no good. Too strong there. Kyle Rose the rebound ahead to Antrell Charlton. Charlton skip pass left side. Kyle Rose gets it back. Charlton, top of the key, three, no good. Off the right side of the iron, and another rebound for Ezeuero going St. Louis's way. In transition, he looks for Hargrove down low, and Hargrove can't handle the pass. Out of bounds on the baseline. It's going back Fordham's way, 16-16 to play. In our first 20, Colin, it's an 8-5 Fordham lead.
The pace has benefited Fordham thus far. The Billikens have not been able to really catch up. It's just not their game plan to do so at that pace. They're more than willing to shoot the ball at will. The problem is when there's not enough ball motion, it looks stagnant at times.
So Jafe Madur walks it up and hands off for the curling Antrell Charlton. Chest pass over to Kyle Rose, top of the key, hesitates on the three, kicks it right corner. Here's Antrell Charlton, right corner three, no good. Much too strong there, but the offensive rebound, Rivera dumps it down low, and Kyle Rose on the second try. A 10-5 start for the Fordham Rams here on the road.
Such an unselfish play from Rivera that time. When you're a big man, your first thought is to go back up with the rock. Smart on his end to find Rose streaking towards the basket.
And the freshman 7-footer mishandles the pass, and Josh Rivera the other way in the one-hand slam. St. Louis turns it over, and Josh Rivera and Co. capitalize with a one-hand finish. A 12-5 start for Fordham. 15:40 to play in our first half. And Colin, that's going to take us to our under 16 media timeout. You're listening to Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
What's up, guys? I'm Julia Moss.
And I'm Will Talent.
And we're two of your hosts for one of WFUV's football podcasts, NFL Friday.
Tune in every Friday for all news and updates around the National Football League.
Also, we'll be making our picks of the week around the league on every episode. Check out NFL Friday wherever you get your podcasts to catch the action.
Welcome back to St. Louis. The Fordham Rams, a 10-0 run in the last 2:52. And if you're wondering what the loud crowd is behind me, it's still a timeout. It's just a shooting promotion going on behind us. I'm not sure what they're giving away. They were giving away some free golf course rounds earlier before the game. Might be something along the lines of that. But here at St. Louis, it's a raucous crowd. And, you know, those Billikens held around early, but these Fordham Rams, 10-0 in the last 2:52. We saw Josh Rivera get loose, a one-hand, right-hand jam. And that's exactly that transition game that feeds off of the Keith Urgo defense.
Fordham's ball movement early has been exceptional. And you're exactly right, Miles. It's been a product of some solid defense. Abdou Simbila has looked better in this game so far. It's something that needed to happen, quite frankly, if they wanted to compete here. Obviously, it hasn't shown up on the stat sheet quite yet, but his box outs have looked a tad crisper. And when you get those sort of box outs, you're going to create opportunities at the other end. You saw it with Kyle Rose and Josh Forever, each earning an assist for the other. So when you play that sort of unselfish basketball, you just know that good things are going to happen. For St. Louis, the question becomes, how can you get the ball into the hands of your best shooters? And is Fordham going to be able to stifle them at the point of attack? So far, they've done that consistently. But if St. Louis is able to shift things around, find open spaces, this could be a very different ball game.
Absolutely, Colin. And as you touched on early in that spiel, is that St. Louis has done a solid job of Fordham moving the basketball like no other. You can see on the offensive end, a lot of open looks. And over the last couple games, as we know, they've lost four to the last five. They carry a two-game losing streak into this one. This is a game where they needed the offense to bounce back, and that's seemingly exactly what it's done.
Fordham is at the stage of the season where the rubber meets the road, quite frankly. Heading into that Duquesne game, there was buzz about this group being a bunch of road warriors and that the road benefited them from a camaraderie standpoint. You cannot necessarily live by that narrative anymore. Now it's about, can you get the young guys and the veterans all on the same page and try and do something really special down the road?
Absolutely, Colin. So here inside Chaffetz Arena, here in St. Louis, Missouri, the farthest west the Fordham Rams have traveled so far this year, the farthest south probably would have been St. Thomas, but this is one of their lengthier road trips of the season. Of course, they know the A-10 doesn't make them travel to both Loyola, Chicago, and SLU in the same year. They break those up, so this time they travel west to St. Louis. They'll be out in Loyola, Chicago next season. But now back underway from Chaffetz. It's a 12-5 start for the Fordham Rams. The freshman 5'11 point guard, Sion Medley, walks it up. Anja Fey-Mador hands off for Jimerson at the top of the circle. He swings it back right side now. It's Zong. Zong the handoff. Here's Parker. Parker two-hand skip pass. Down to the man in the corner. Stuck in the corner is Thames, and Thames can't handle it. It's poked out of free. Poked out of his hands, pardon me. Last touch by the Fordham Rams. Staying right here in the offensive half of St. Louis. It'll be the near sideline inbound with just 6 seconds on the shot clock.
Zong in for SLU now. The 7-footer, not a great offensive talent, but just helps create space, if nothing else.
3 seconds on the shot clock. He'll have to pull as the freshman Medley, no good. Off the right iron on the mid-range J. And Keith Urgo is fired up coming off the stop. Jameer Tripp pushes up in the left side mid-post. Back to the basket. Spins around on the freshman. Medley rises with the right hand, and he's well short there, but he gets his own miss. Bounces high post. Now the extra pass. Here's Josh Rivera. Dribble drive the right side, and he'll draw the block. This one's going to be on Kellen Thames, the sophomore out of St. Louis, who just checked in. So that'll stop the clock with 14:51 to play in our first half. It's a 12-5 Fordham lead, and it's Ram basketball on the offensive baseline.
Antrell Charlton got the ball at the top of the key. There was a time this season where he would have just fired at will. good on him to make the extra pass, as you said there, Miles.
Josh Rivera floats at high post. Jaffe Madore can't handle the pass. It's poked out of play. Last touch by Thames himself. So staying right here with the Fordham Rams, 14-48 first half. They lead 12-5 over the Billikens, and the Billikens carry a five-game losing streak into today, looking to bounce back.
Now that's a group that's definitely looking to get off the schneid, so to speak.
Here's Jaffe Madore, left elbow, drives in, hangs, no good. Too strong with the left hand, but he gets his own miss. Back up top for Josh Rivera, dribble penetration, and he loses the dribble now. Poked free into the hands of here, it's Larry Hughes. Larry Hughes flips it high post for the freshman in Zong. Zong at the top of the key. Back to Hughes, the give and go, down low for Zong. He cuts in and draws the contact. So this one will be on the floor, near side referee says. That'll stop the clock. 14:21 to play in our first half. It's 12-5. The Fordham Rams on top. Billikens ball.
Billikens just look a touch confused offensively, really. Zong got the ball. He froze in his shoes. He's not used to being in this type of situation where the team's relying on him to create space and maybe do something for them offensively.
Jaffe Madore off. Will Richardson on. Abdu off. And Elijah Gray on. So going for the younger guys over the subs here as Keith Ergo gets a word from a near side referee, making sure the scorekeeper could still have eyes on the game. Back underway here from St. Louis. Here's Jimerson, left block, the scoop, no good, well short through the contact of Elijah Gray, and he's no good on the second time either. Here's Antrell Charlton, the rebound, a burst of speed in the offensive half, kicks it right corner. And well short there was Josh Rivera on the three-point attempt, and he immediately commits the frustration foul in on Sincere Parker there. Of course, on the floor in transition, but another clock stoppage with 14:06 to play. Low-scoring affair as of late, Colin. 12-5 is the Fordham lead.
Fordham shooting 14% from range. This game would look a lot different had they made some of those buckets. The reason they're not, quite frankly, is because they're rushing some of these shots. They've been wide open on a couple of looks, and instead of collecting themselves and just sinking the bucket, they've overthought it in some sense.
Sincere Parker pulls up left elbow, and he rattles home the jumper. That ends a 4.5-minute scoreless drought there for St. Louis. It's a 12-7 Fordham Ram lead. Now Will Richardson to walk it up, moving left to right, angles his way to the left perimeter. Hands off for Jameer Tripp, bounces high post. Here's Antrell Charlton, 20 seconds on the shot clock. He'll skip it down low for Josh Rivera. Left block, he'll rise, and he's no good from under the basket. And they'll say last touch, Josh Rivera. Some good pressure from Ezzolero. And an empty possession there for the Fordham Rams. 13.5 to play in the first half. It's 12-7. Fordham Rams on top. St. Louis basketball of Yole Akuovo checking on for Elijah Gray. And Elijah Gray limps off.
And Fordham certainly hoping Elijah Gray is okay. His presence has made a huge difference this season. We'll have to keep our eyes on him.
So Sincere Parker taking his time to walk it up, moving right to left in the home whites of St. Louis here at Chavez Arena. Sincere Parker, top of the key. Pretty move, angles his way to the right side. Fadeaway jumper from the right side, and no good. Bounced out of play there. No one could corral the rebound. They'll say last touch, St. Louis. So it's Fordham Ram basketball, 13-15 first half, 12-7 Rams.
Sincere Parker coming off of a 14.6 rebound performance at Loyola Chicago. Not an outside scorer, but don't allow him to work his way towards the mid-range.
Richardson kicks it left, dark. Here's Antrell Charlton back to Richardson on the righty slot. Richardson burst of speed ahead, pulls up from 10 feet, no good. Off the right side of the iron there, and Kellen Thames, the backup guard, rips down the Billiken rebound. Swings it ahead. Here's Hughes. Larry Hughes over to Churchich. George Churchich. Skip pass right side. Here's Thames. Thames dribble drive from the right side. A foul on the floor. This will be on Josh Rivera. A little too aggressive there. So Ramad Dean will now sub in for Josh Rivera. And foul trouble becoming a bit of a theme for the Fordham Rams. Lots of consistent substitutions.
And it's surprising considering the pace of this game that hasn't been a whole lot of stoppages. Typically when the game is running fast and loose, the officials are content to let the players play. But in this instance, these guys are racking up some fouls early.
So back underway, here's Larry Hughes, top of the key. Dribble drive left side, he got it poked free by Will Richardson. Jameer Tripp comes up with it. Tripp bounces ahead, now it's Antrell Charlton across the timeline, 12.5 to play first half. Ramad Dean, left arc three, no good. Well short off the left side of the iron as Alero pulls down the Billiken board. 12-7, Rams on top. Sincere Parker, dribble drive left side. He draws contact in transition. So two free throws coming out of the right hand to Sincere Parker, the JUCO kid who actually missed the first 11 games of the year. He broke his foot on November 16th in their first game, and he's a big part of Travis Ford's attack. So he will step up to the free throw line now, and St. Louis, of course, very happy to have him back.
Parker averaging 12.5 points per game, shoots around 28% from long range. Not his forte out there, but if you let him work his way inside, he's more than happy to take some charity stripe attempts, Miles.
So no good off the front of the iron, so the Fordham lead holds at 12-7 here with 12:17 to play in our first 20 minutes. Shamir Tripp off. Looks like Kyle Rose will check back on. Here's the second free throw out of the righty hand of Sincere Parker, and nothing but net on the second, so brings St. Louis back within four. It's 12-8, Fordham Rams on top, and now some full court pressure out of the Billikens in white. Kyle Rose inbounds to Will Richardson, and he'll walk it up on the backup guard, George Churchich. Richardson crosses the timeline on the near side for court. And he kicks a high post. Here's Antrell Charlton, two-hand overhead pass down low. Ramad Dean, left block, spins around and rises and kisses it off the glass and gets it to go. A 14-8 lead now for the Fordham Rams. 11:55 to play in our first half. Here's Medley, top of the circle, bounces down low. As Alero loses the dribble in the center of the key there, and Kyle Rose picks up another steal. Dishes it right side, and it's a loose ball. It's a scrum. Who's going to come up with it? Ramad Dean flips it to Richardson, and he gets fouled. Will Richardson draws the contact, and the Fordham bench is fired up. 11:36 to play in our first half, and the Fordham Rams a 14-8 lead here on the road.
And Coach Ergo just gave the fist pumps of all fist pumps. I don't know if I've ever seen him that excited in his entire tenure at Fordham. What a series. You get a tough basket from Ramad Dean. Then your guys hit the floor trying to get a steal. Fordham knows this is a critical juncture of the game. They have to keep ahead of a SLU team that is trying to wear them down.
So both teams ice cold from the field as of late. SLU one of their last nine, and Fordham one of their last seven. But those Rams lead 14-8 here on the road. 11:36 to play in our first 20. But with that, we'll take a quick break and send it back to our Rose Hill studios for a scoreboard update with Michael Matuch.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Atlantic 10 basketball continues to have close games throughout as the LaSalle Explorers could not find a way to win as St. Joseph's Hawks toppled them 88-82. In the battle of the Minutemen versus the Patriots, the Minutemen emerged victorious as the UMass triumphed over George Mason 66-65. And the Duquesne Dukes demolished the Rhode Island Rams with a demanding 85-71 victory. The number one ranked UConn suited up in their rain jackets and were Red Storm chasers all game long and waded through St. John hoops and coach Rick Pitino with a final score of 77-64 from the Garden. Connor McDavid is $1 million richer after winning the NHL All-Star Skills Competition. McDavid won the Fastest Skaters event, the Stick Handling Challenge, and the NHL Accuracy Shooting. McDavid has continued to prove that he is the best player of this generation in the National Hockey League. I'm Michael Matuch with your one-on-one scoreboard update.
Your Fordham Rams lead the St. Louis Billikens here from Chaffetz Arena here in downtown St. Louis. Miles Grossman alongside Colin Loughran. And Colin, these Fordham Rams had fallen in their last two games. They needed an offensive outburst, really, in this first half, and that's exactly what they've gotten in the early going. 14-8, they lead.
It's been a hotly contested first half thus far. SLU, towards the last couple of minutes or so, was starting to wear Fordham down and touch. They got a big basket from Ramad Dean, a gritty steal from, I believe, Kyle Rose, and this year, SLU is 2-10 when their opponent shoots better. Fordham shooting at a better clip than SLU at the moment. So if that holds true, the Rams could be in for a victory. On the flip side, though, if St. Louis is content to play at Fordham's pace and they adapt correctly, we could be talking about completely different factors down the stretch.
And both squads extremely cold from the field. No one above 4 points for the Fordham Rams. Ramada Dean up to four. Elijah Gray with four. And of course, only three scores even into the box score for St. Louis, and their leading scorer with just 3 points in Sincere Parker. So back underway from St. Louis, it's a 14-8 Fordham Ram lead with the basketball. Here's Will Richardson stands on the left arc, two-hand pass, right corner. Antrell Charlton, he'll pop the three, and he's nothing but net. Antrell Charlton gets it to go. It's a 17-8 lead for the Fordham Rams.
Very clean offensive possession. Had the St. Louis defenders' heads on swivels that time.
Medley flips high post. Will Richardson picks it off with the right hand. He's loose in the backcourt. He rises and he's blocked. As Aguero swats it out of play, it'll stay right here with the Fordham Rams. But the transition opportunity, and the Fordham Rams do not come up on top there. It's 11:03 to play in our first half, a 17-8 Fordham Ram lead with the ball.
And what a block by Aguero. Has some collegiate experience that speaks for itself between LSU and Georgetown. He's been around the block.
Here's Will Richardson, right elbow, dribble drive left side, rises and draws some contact. And they'll call the jump ball here. And the possession arrow stays right here with the Fordham Rams. 17-8 they lead, 10:59 to play in our first 20. And Kyle Rose will be the trigger man. And Kyle Rose, we're looking for many more points out of him today as opposed to his last two, am I right?
No doubt about that.
Rose, left side, dribble drive, works his way in, and it's swatted back. Hargrove with the rejection. And Sincere Parker comes down with it. Now back to Hargrove at the top of the key. Hargrove looking to bounce it to the freshman in Medley. He can't find him, and now he'll find the handoff at the top of the circle. Medley lobs it down low as Aguero rises right block. He's much too strong there. Will Richardson can't handle it, but Antrell Charlton rips it free this time, and now the Fordham Rams moving left to right ahead to Elijah Gray, and he's got the lay off the window and down, and a 19-8 Fordham Ram lead.
Elijah Gray looks okay to me, Miles. That is a good sign for Fordham. Gray got down the court very quickly, finished the fast break opportunity.
Here's the freshman Medley on the right arc. He'll bounce in high post for Sincere Parker. The handoff for Hargrove at the top of the key. Two-hand overhead pass. It's Jimerson. Jimerson bounces down low as Aguero rises from the left side, and he's got it to go. Off a couple bounces and down, and the lead is shrunk to just 9 now, 19-10.
Jimerson with a shifty shuffle pass into the key. Point guard-esque read there.
Kyle Rose transition, right arc three, no good. On the left side of the iron, and Elijah Gray, the offensive rebound. Here's Will Richardson, top of the key, skip pass right side. Kyle Rose got it on the second try, and a 22-10 lead for the Fordham Rams. What ball movement.
Entering today, Kyle Rose led the team with 35 made threes. Another one right there.
Here's Medley, top of the circle, probes and flips it right side for Hargrove. Right side three, no good. Off the right side of the iron, and Ramad Dean pulls down the Fordham rebound and ahead to Antrell Charlton. Charlton, two-hand overhead pass into the hands of Kyle Rose, who just saved it on the far sideline. Kyle Rose, left arc, up top for Elijah Gray. He'll pop the three, no good. Off the right side of the iron, and the freshman at 5'11", Medley, rises, pulls it down, ahead to Jimerson. Transition triple, and he's got it to go from the left arc. A big slew bucket there brings them back within single digits. It's 22-13 Fordham.
That's Jimerson's bread and butter. Those are his first points of the day. He will happily take a transition three every day of the week.
8:45 to play in our first half. Will Richardson, right arc three, no good, too strong off the heel. And a rebound into the hands of Terrence Hargrove ahead to the freshman in Medley. Medley to Hargrove on the left elbow. Flip it back up top. Medley probes, top of the circle. Antrell Charlton applies the pressure. Medley fakes the pull-up from 10, bounces down low for Azuero. Azuero rises, and that's some Elijah Gray contact. Much too strong there on the foul, and that'll be two free throws coming for Bradley Azuero, the junior forward. So a clock stoppage with 8:23 to play in our first half. Fordham on top, 22-13, with two free throws coming for Azuero.
Azuero has been deadly this season for SLU. Leads the team with 6.5 rebounds per game, shooting around 53% from the field. Last time out, had 7 points, 2 of 10 from the field with 5 boards against Loyola Chicago.
And the lefty free throw falls there, and Azuero brings SLU back within 8 now. 22-14 is the Fordham lead, and Colony's one of these guys that definitely has Power 5 pedigree when you look at his resume. Began his career in the Big East at Georgetown, over to LSU, and then got his career started pretty late here at SLU because he just got his waiver approved 10 games ago. He's in and out on the second free throw, and Ramad Dean pulls it down now in their road maroons. Moving left to right, here's Jaffe Madore. Madore bounces high post for Kyle Rose. He'll skip it left side. It's Will Richardson now top of the key. An extra pass to Elijah Gray. He'll pull it from the left side, and he's got the mid-range jumper to fall. 24-14, Fordham back up double digits.
And that's not an easy shot for a bigger athlete to hit off the dribble like that. Very impressive from the sophomore.
Medley swing pass over to in the hands of Richardson. Will Richardson, his second steal of the day in transition back to Kyle Rose, and Rose the two-hand lay. 26-14, and the St. Louis crowd is silenced, but they take it right out of the basket, and Bradley Ezuero, the two-hand slam in transition. Back to a 10-point game, 26-16 Fordham. 7.5 to play in our first half.
Ezuero huffing and puffing up the court that time to catch up to the ball, finished it with the slam.
So Jaffe Madore content to milk some clock here, and now we got a referee stoppage. And we'll see what the call is here. And it looks like we have the on-the-floor timeout, given that it is a USA Network national televised game. Our referees were forced to take the media timeout there, so we got to get the ads in, Colin.
A-10 going a little Hollywood here, Miles.
Exactly right. So we've seen this throughout Saturdays. It's the USA Network Saturday Atlantic 10 Showcase, but that'll be another clock stoppage with 7:25 to play in our first 20. Fordham on top, 26-16. This is Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
Hi, this is Michael Kay, WFUV class of 1982. WFUV is your home for all things Fordham athletics, with live coverage of Fordham football, Fordham men's and women's basketball, in addition to our Saturday show, One-on-One. Stay right here on 90.7 FM for all things WFUV sports.
And welcome back to Chaffetz Arena, a 26-16 lead for your Fordham Rams on the road. And Colin, as we touched on at the top of the broadcast, this is a St. Louis team off to their worst start in Atlantic 10 play since they joined the conference. And particularly under Travis Ford, they've made a routine of just being the team at the top of the conference. It's almost shocking to see a 1-7 start in Atlantic 10 play, but watching this early going stretch, you can kind of see why. A couple holes defensively, and it seems like a group still looking to find themselves.
And I doubt that there's many fans, if any at all, St. Louis fans that is, that are panicking over this slow start or down year, if you will. It's a program that has had a lot of success over the years. You think of some of the great players that have come from St. Louis. Anthony Bonner, for those New York Knicks fans listening in New York, a key part of that 1994 run in the NBA Finals. But all in all, Miles, Ford will right the ship at a certain point. It may not be this year, but you've got to believe that a coach that's been around the block, such as him, with blue chip DNA, I might add, played for Kentucky, was a part of that 1993 Final Four team, he will figure it out in due time.
That's a good point, Colin. And you really can tell this St. Louis group is one that's comfortable playing college basketball. You just wonder if they're comfortable playing college basketball with one another. And interestingly enough, this is the 20th meeting all time between these two Jesuit institutions. The Billikens lead the all-time series 15-4, and believe it or not, the Rams have never won in St. Louis. They've made this road trip 9 times. They're 0-9. Could be a big win for the program today.
Oh, you can't jinx it like that, Miles. You can't do that. That's a cardinal rule. Not even a little superstitious.
Cardinal rule here in St. Louis. But back underway here from Chaffetz. Kyle Rose flips it high post for Will Richardson. It's 26-16. Rams on top. Elijah Gray mid post rises with a scoop. He's no good off the back of the heel. And Hargrove rips down the St. Louis rebound ahead to the freshman Medley. Medley's got it on the right side perimeter. Takes the Zong screen. Medley skip pass high post. It's Hargrove. Hargrove the handoff for Jimerson on the left side perimeter. Back to the 7-foot freshman out of China, Zong. He'll hand off for Medley at the top of the circle. Burst of speed to the right side. Works his way into the lane. Kicks it left arc. Hargrove left side three, and he's got it. drained the shot clock there and got it to fall. It's a 26-19 Fordham lead. St. Louis, a pretty bucket there. Here's Kyle Rose on the right arc, left-hand dribble with the knee high. Flips it up for Ahmad Dean. Now back to Elijah Gray at the top of the circle. The extra pass to Will Richardson. Now Kyle Rose stuck in the right corner in on Hargrove. Thought about the three. Now he pulls it. He's no good. Too strong there. And the rebound for Medley ahead.
St. Louis starting to creep up. This has happened to Fordham a few times in conference play. They've gotten off to a good start, and they've let opponents begin to wear them down.
26-19, Fordham on top with 6 minutes to play in our first half. Zong looking down low for Hargrove, and Hargrove can't handle the pass, but he'll be fouled on the floor. We'll say this one's on Ramad Dean, and Jafe Medor that time getting a talking to from Keith Thurlow. Looked like he was the one who missed the defensive assignment there. But another clock stoppage, 6 minutes and 5 seconds. It's 26-19, Fordham on top. But Hargrove stepping to the free throw line, and Terrence Hargrove, his first free throw attempts of the day.
Hargrove with two made threes already. He's the kind of guy that seems to rise to the occasion during A-10 play. Shot over 50% from field last year in conference play.
So Fordham on top, 26-19. 6:05 to play. Here's Hargrove, the righty free throw, and he's got the front end to fall. For St. Louis in the bonus for the final 6 minutes of our first half. And Terrence Hargrove in his fifth year with the program. Senior 6'5" out of East St. Louis. Believe it or not, East St. Louis is just across the state line in Illinois. But he crosses his state line back over to St. Louis, Missouri for his college career, and he wraps up the 2-of-2 trip and brings St. Louis back within just 5 points. It's 26-21, 6 minutes flat to play. Jafe Medor to walk it up in a burst of speed. Dishes left arc, here's Kyle Rose, dribbles between the legs, on the left arc, the knee-high dribble with the left hand, he'll bounce it down low. Elijah Gray, left side mid-post, looking inside for Abdu. Abdu rises with the right hand, and he's too strong, fighting for his own miss, and he can't get it. Ahead to Medley, and now another offensive possession for the Billikens. The freshman, a burst of speed down low, drops it in for Zong. Zong rises with the righty hook, no good on the turnaround. And Kyle Rose the rebound, now pushing left to right for the Fordham Rams and their Maroons. Up top for Elijah Gray. He's got it. He looks down low for Abdu Simbila on the bounce pass. Right block, Abdu rises, and he's blocked. Last touch by the freshman, Bruce Zong, and our first taste of the Bruce chance that we were very excited to hear here in St. Louis. But the possession will stay here with the Fordham Rams. The freshman 7-footer out of China gets the block out of play.
And gets the better of Abdu Simbila. Simbila has really struggled. No rebounds, 0-of-3 from the field last time out against Richmond.
Here's Rose, top of the circle, crosses left to right between the legs, pulls the jumper on Hughes, and he cans it. A pretty finish right there on a 28-21 Fordham lead. 5:02 to play in the first half. Here's Zong, bounces down low for the cutting Zimmer. Excuse me, Jimerson. And the ball's out of play. Let's see who had the last touch. This one's going to be off Elijah Gray. So the possession staying right here with the St. Louis Billikens in their home whites.
Elijah Gray not happy at all. He's claiming that Zong grabbed him as he attempted to save the ball. So physical play from Zong, not one that you'd be accustomed to seeing from a freshman, Miles, albeit a freshman center that is in the ballgame to provide those sort of physical plays.
Absolutely. And Elijah Gray will check off there. Ahmad Dean will check back in. 4:56 to play in our first half. Here's Ezeuero on the right arc. He hands off for Jimerson. Jimerson dumps it down low for the cutting Ezeuero, and he rises, and he's blocked by Abdu Simbila. And last touch, Ezeuero. Abdu has been so cold the last four games with a big defensive stop there. Gives it back to the Fordham Rams. It's 28-21 Rams, 4:46 to play first half.
And that was not an easy defensive set for Fordham. Jimerson so crafty with his ability to move with the basketball and manipulate how his guys and the opposing team moves on the court.
Antrell Charlton got it on the left arc, lobs it in for Abdu Simbila, and Abdu can't handle the pass. Into the hands of Terrence Hargrove, and he'll dish it ahead now once again for Sion Medley. Medley drills behind the back, and it's picked off by Ramad Dean. Dean ahead. Rams got numbers. They'll kick it. Left arc. Madure. Left arc three. No good. Off the back of the heel. Too strong there. And now once again a transition affair. Here's Hargrove moving right to left. And he is fouled on the floor. This one's on Antral Charlton. And with the bonus situation here, 4:15 to play in our first half. It'll be a 1-1 once again for Terrence Hargrove.
And Abdou Simbila chugging up the court on that last possession. He looks a touch slow in this one. He hasn't looked great in conference play, Miles. It's something Fordham is going to have to reckon with as the season continues. He's their best rim protector without question. Without him, their defense has a massive hole inside.
Absolutely, and Terrence Hargrove now steps up to the free throw line. He's just a 76%er on the campaign, but already 2 of 2 on the day. It's a 28-21 Fordham lead. Here's the righty free throw of Hargrove, and he's around and out on the front end of the 1-1, and Abdu rips it out of the hands of Ramad Dean there and bounces it up for Antral Charlton. Charlton to walk it up now, moving left to right. 21 seconds on the shot clock as he crosses the timeline. Here's Charlton. Curls around on the A-10 logo, kicks it right side. Kyle Rose, right arc three, and he gets it to go. 31-21, Fordham back up double digits.
Coach Ergo has reminded us a couple times that Antral Charlton's a pure point guard. That was a point guard's pass.
Here's Larry Hughes. Spin around on the left side mid post. He'll bounce it inside for Ezuero. Back to Larry Hughes on the left arc. Kyle Rose applies the pressure. Pull up jumper. Hughes. No good off the right side of the iron, but the offensive rebound. Ezuero back to Hughes. He'll pull up and he'll can it on the second time just beyond the 3-point line. And it's a 31-24 St. Louis lead. They find the answer.
Larry Hughes with a critical shot for St. Louis makes this one single digits.
Charlton kicks left arc. Rose another triple and he rattles it home. Another three out of the hand of Kyle Rose and a 34-24 lead. Just exchanging threes.
Gotta do it blow for blow, Miles, like two fighters in a ring.
Here's Larry Hughes, bounces high post, gets it back from Ezuero, and another bounce down low, and Ezuero the finish through the contact, and an and-one opportunity for St. Louis. Both offenses heating up here from Javits Arena. It's a 34-26 Fordham lead, 3:01 to play. Colin, after an early defensive slugfest, it's really heated up.
Ezuero now with 9 points, primarily coming from inside the painted area. That is a product of not having your best rim protector at his best. Really, St. Louis has been able to draw plays where he's Ryan free down there. That's going to be a focal point in the second half, is can you slow him down in the paint?
So Fordham 34, St. Louis 26 here at home. 3:01 to play here in our first 20, but we're going to take a quick break and send it back to our Rose Hill studios for a scoreboard update with Michael Matuch.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Two of the top 25 NCAA basketball teams currently have games underway. Ninth-ranked Marquette is going to town in Georgetown. The Golden Eagles are up double, 44-22 over the Hoyas at the half. We have an upset in the making as the unranked Texas Longhorns are ahead of the 25th-ranked TCU Horned Frogs, 43-32. Their second half is about to kick off. The Virginia Cavaliers are having their way with the Clemson Tigers. They are ahead 44-37. Taking it up to Toronto, the NHL All-Star Game is kicking off. Team McKinnon will be joined by Sidney Crosby and Cale Makar as he takes on NHL All-Star Skills Competition, Connor McDavid, and Leon Draisaitl and Rasmus Dahlin. I'm Michael Matuch with your one-on-one scoreboard update.
Welcome back to St. Louis. It's a 34-26 lead for your Fordham Rams over the Billikens here on their home turf. And Colin, I mean, these Fordham Rams, offensively speaking, have been moving the rock awfully well. Kyle Rose on top of that, 3 of 6 from downtown, finishing off some pretty well ball-moved possessions.
Kyle Rose, last time out, 10.7 rebounds. Well on track to exceed that number. Has already done so from a points perspective. 10 points, you'd imagine he would score again in this one, Miles, with the way Fordham's been moving and grooving on the offensive end of things. For St. Louis, you start to wonder when you're going to see someone like Jimerson begin to get his looks. He's been somewhat quiet in this one. He's only attempted 2 shots from the field. It's really been about Ezuero. so far for St. Louis. He's been brilliant in the paint. Outside, though, the Billikens have not looked like their normal selves. That's not to say that they're a three-point shooting team, but they'll take open threes when they get them, and they can knock them down. It's just a matter of creating their own space, creating their own separation in the way that Fordham's been able to do for themselves.
And the bulk of the way for this St. Louis offense has really been the undersized point guard, Sion Medley, trying to play that two game with Ezeuero down low. Of course, we've had a couple open threes out of the right hand of Terrence Hargrove, but for the vast majority of it, it's this high and low game, the undersized point guard and the big man down low. Colin, I think the biggest thing for the Fordham Rams defensively is shutting down Ezeuero on that left block.
And you're going to need Abdu Simbila to step up in a big way. Either that, or you're going to need big minutes from Yole Akowovo at some point in this one.
So Ezeuero stands at the free throw line. He wraps up the productive trip. It's a 34-27 Fordham lead here on the road. Jaffe Madore in the road maroons moving left to right. He'll bounce at high post as Antrell Charlton on the St. Louis logo. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Now he'll start the possession. Angles to the right side of the perimeter and some pressure in on Ezeuero. And Ezeuero is whistled for the reach-in. So Antrell Charlton draws the contact. And as you can hear, the St. Louis crowd does not like the call. But with 2:46 to play in the half, it'll be Fordham Ram basketball near sideline inbound.
And Charlton running point with Jaffe Madore also on the court. Charlton, a pure point guard by definition, according to Coach Ergo and others, so far today has 3 assists, only 3 points. So he's making a concerted effort to be that facilitator for the Rams.
Cowro skips it down low, left block, and Antrell Charlton gets it to go off the window in a 36-27 Fordham lead.
And sometimes those facilitators get rewarded. 2 miles, a nice cut to the basket from the senior.
2:35 to play in our first half. Here's Larry Hughes, top of the circle, angles to the right side of the perimeter, looks down low for the pass, but Ramad Dean has it, and he can't handle. We'll see who had the last touch as a dribble out of play on the far sideline. It's between Terrence Hargrove and Ramad Dean. They'll say Ramad Dean the final touch. So the right sideline inbound for the Billikens in their home whites. It'll stay here with 2:27 to play in our first half. It's 36-27. Fordham has led for virtually the entirety of this first half.
And Ramad Dean with a bit of a haphazard attempt to grab the basketball. It's times like that where I wonder if he's a pure wing or if he could be moved down low towards that post area. He's only a sophomore, so a lot of time for him to figure that out yet.
Hargrove swings it inside for Bradley Ezeuero at the top of the key. Here's Larry Hughes. Left side dribble drive, pulls up from 10 and rattles home the mid-range J. Slew right back within 7. It's 36-29, 2:15 and ticking. Jaffe Madore now the waist-high dribble with the right hand as he crosses the mid-court stripe. Hands off for Antrell Charlton. Charlton looks to kick it to Rose. He regains on the left arc. Rose back to the basket, top of the key. He'll get it to Antrell Charlton. Charlton back to Rose on the right arc. Fakes the pull-up, drives inside, and he gets clamored right there. Ezeuero, the guilty party. And Kyle Rose will be headed to the free throw line with 1:55 to play. It's a 36-29 Ram lead.
And you have to wonder, with the way that Fordham has shot the ball from the free throw line, are fouls like that something that Coach Ford is willing to accept on St. Louis' side? I would imagine he told his guys no easy baskets in this one. You cannot let Fordham get wide open looks. If they're going to attack towards the rim, foul him and make him earn it. Go on.
So Kyle Rose, just a 58%er on the campaign. The lefty free throw falls, and that grows the Fordham lead to 37-29, back to 8 points. One more free throw coming out of the left hand of Kyle Rose as Bruce Zong, the freshman 7-footer out of China, checks back on for a final minute 55 of the half.
Zong has seen a lot of time for Slew today, more than I thought he would, honestly, Miles.
And a 2-of-2 trip there, nothing but net for Kyle Rose. Rose immediately gets subbed off for the likes of Will Richardson. And so a 38-29 Fordham advantage with 1:55 to play in our first half. And a burst of speed up for Larry Hughes as he crosses the timeline. Hands off for the curling Jimerson. Jimerson on the right arc now. Hargrove got it on the right arc. He flips it down low for Zong. Zong back to the basket looking for a pretty move on Simbila. Still working his way in back to the basket. Right arc. He rises and he gets it to go off the window. Patient as he works his way inside and he gets it to go. 38-31, the Fordham lead.
That is unacceptable defense from Abdu Simbila. Once Zong puts the ball on the floor, you have to jar it loose if you're Simbila.
And Charlton, pull up, right arc. Well short there. off the left side of the iron, and an easy rebound into the hands of Larry Hughes now. 1:11 to play in our first half. It's 38-31, Rams on top. Here's Hargrove, right side, top of the key now. He gets fouled on the floor. This one's on Antrell Charlton, and with the bonus in play here, it'll be a 1-1. And of course, Keith Urgo extremely frustrated with the careless foul, far from the basket.
And doesn't this feel familiar, Miles? St. Louis starting to creep their way back up on the scoreboard. This could be way closer at halftime than we initially thought it was going to be. And that changes the way that you play the second half if you're St. Louis or if you're Fordham for that matter. Even if you have a lead at halftime, that does not guarantee anything. The Rams have found that out the hard way multiple times this year.
And Terrence Hargrove well short off the front of the iron there. So Fordham escapes at the moment. It's 38-31 with 1:03 on our first half clock. And Terrence Hargrove has gotten to the lane and gotten to the line quite a bit in our first half. His fifth attempt in the first 20. Deeply bends the knees, rises, and he gets it to fall. Brings St. Louis back within six. It's 38-32, 1:02 to play.
And you have Jimerson guarding Jaffe Madure. Picked him up at half court. That is an interesting matchup selection on St. Louis' part.
Jaffe Madure crosses the timeline at the top of the circle now. Angles his way left side mid post, kicks it left side. Ramad Dean the triple, and he got it. A beautiful shot from the left corner. Keith Urgo wants the timeout, but it's a 41-32 Fordham Ram lead. 46 seconds to play in the first half.
Jaffe Madure picks up the assist, just kind of shook off Jimerson. I mentioned it was interesting precisely because Jimerson is a much bigger player. There is not a good probability that he'll be able to keep up with Madure from a footwork perspective. So the point guard just able to weave his way towards the paint, find the outlet in the corner for the open three.
Fordham's biggest lead of the day has been 12 points, and they're narrowing in on that once again, getting back to those double digits. But Colin, it's been the 20 minutes that you could have hoped for out of the Fordham Rams. Really everything you could want and more. Keith Urgo, you could really tell last time we spoke to him, the anxiety was starting to brew. You can't just win your games in non-con, fall in Atlantic 10 and be content, right? And I think that anxiety was starting to set in, but this first half is exactly what the Fordham Rams needed.
And they're certainly happy that Kyle Rose is on their team, Miles. 17 points, 3 assists, 2 rebounds. We're used to the rebound numbers. We are used to the assist numbers from Kyle Rose. The scoring has been a question at different points during this season. He's been very good in A-10 play with another notch on his belt this afternoon.
Yeah, great point, Colin. Kyle Rose up to 17-3. Also, 2 rebounds to his credit in our first half. But St. Louis to walk it up in their home whites, moving right to left. Larry Hughes draws 2 defenders at the top of the circle, flips it back to Hargrove. Hargrove to Hughes. Now to Hargrove. He'll pop the left arc 3. No good off the right side of the iron. Ramad Dean pulls it down. And Keith Urgo says, hold for the final possession. About a half a second difference between our shot clock and our game clock here from St. Louis. It's a 41-32 lead for the Fordham Rams. 41 in that first half.
And I am entirely surprised that they are going to let the clock run out here. It's not what we're accustomed to seeing, but I love the choice.
10 seconds in the half. Here's Jaffe Madure. Burst of speed on the left elbow. Pulls it back. Rises. And they'll call the foul. He got the finish, but the foul came on the floor. So with 4.1 seconds to play, Jaffe Madure draws the contact, and the Fordham Rams not in the bonus yet. It'll just be the sideline inbound with 4.1 to play in the half.
And the Fordham bench thought that was going to be an end one opportunity, and what a three-point play that would have been. That officially would have put them in position with a double-digit lead.
Ramad Dean, the trigger man, flips it left arc. Here's Madure, dribble drive, 1 second to play in the half. He rises and he's no good off the heel. And that's how our first 20 comes to an end. A 9-point lead for the Fordham Rams at the break. It's 41-32 here from St. Louis.
Both teams shooting at around 42%. Fordham has gotten a great performance out of Kyle Rose. The question now becomes, can St. Louis figure something out that's more sustainable offensively and is not reliant on that high-low pairing?
And Kyle Rose in his 130th appearance as a Fordham Ram. He picked up his career high just 3 games ago at 24. And now would you look at him, 17 points in our first 20 minutes from St. Louis. Certainly destined for another career high. But the Fordham Rams lead 41-32 at the break from St. Louis. But we'll take a quick break from Colin and I and send it back to our Rose Hill studios for the halftime show with Owen Kelty and Michael Matuch.
The one-on-one halftime report.
Welcome into the Rose Hill studios for the one-on-one halftime show. I'm Owen Kelty. Joining me is Michael Matuch. The Fordham Rams lead this one 41-32. And just like Miles and Colin said before they sent it back to us, this is the best 20 minutes you could have asked for if you're the Rams. Kyle Rose has been on fire leading the team with 17 points so far in the first half. So what have you seen that you've liked so far from this team the first half?
From games past to this current first half, I feel we're really putting what we need to put together. We're focusing on improving our weaknesses, and we're keeping what we do well. We're keeping that rolling forward. And I'm really impressed with how Kyle Rose is just being dominant and being a stud all around.
He's been absolutely on fire to start this one. 17 points, 6 of 10 shooting, 3 of 6 from 3. But right from the beginning of this game, Fordham has felt like they've dominated defensively. Offensively, 41 points is always great. A little shaky from 3, but as always, you know, those aren't always going to go down. But they've been winning this game on the defensive side of the ball, absolutely dominating. There's been multiple stretches throughout this game where St. Louis has gone 3-4 minutes without scoring. You'd think this lead would be bigger than 9 points. They've had the lead as big as 12, and that's going to be huge for the second half, is kind of staying and keeping that lead, not letting them crawl back in. But I just want to get into their defense. What have you seen from their defense that's kind of led to them to kind of dominating this first half?
I'm just seeing the way we're commanding the ball and commanding this defense in the paint is really just impressive. We're having the lead for 18 minutes out of the first 20. And if we're able to have a commanding defense and really shut down the opponent is really big. In a lot of games past, we've really, really struggled with turnovers. And that is not happening today. We have 10, we have received 10 turnovers from St. Louis versus our 2 that we've given them. And that, I feel like that's one of the biggest parts of us having this lead at the half so far.
And you look at, for Fordham's defense, they have 9 steals. When was the last time you thought looked at a box score and saw a team had 9 steals in the first half? And that's been, you brought up, they've been leading this game for 18 minutes. That is a dominant first half from this Fordham Rams team. And when you look at what St. Louis has done offensively, they're shooting slightly better from the field, but they've only taken 8 threes compared to Fordham's 18, Fordham's 6 of 18 from 3 for 33%. But being able to hold them off of that 3-point line, I think, is key for this Fordham team. They've been doing that well this year, is keeping teams off that 3-point line and kind of forcing them into the paint, but their problem's been stopping them in the paint.
We do got a lot of big guys in the paint, though. We got a lot of tall guys, and I feel like if Coach Ergo, he's getting riled up during this game, and I'm so happy to see that. Colin was talking about how he's seeing more excitement from Ergo in this game than he has throughout his entire tenure, and I can really feel it here in the studio, just by the way the team is competing and the team is moving forward throughout this half.
And I think some important things that you can look at for this Fordham team, when you look at their box score, Jafe Madore, the team's leading scorer on the season, he's 1 for 4 for 2 points. But Fordham is going into the half with a 9-point lead. And guys who have been having a great year this year, Elijah Gray, the sophomore, only 8 points, 3 of 5. It's really shown how important this first half has been from Kyle Rose. But for a team that has been kind of back and forth all year, being able to spread out that scoring, I think, is really huge for this offense.
That is what we really have to push for this second half, because we've seen it where our guys, we compete really, really hard in this first half, these first 20 minutes, and then that same guy isn't able to really compete for the rest of the game. If we want this to be a successful game against a team that's kind of floundering around as of St. Louis, we need to have other guys step up. It can't just be a one-man show.
Yeah, and like you said, like St. Louis is 1-7 in A-10 play. They've been struggling, and going into the half down 9 points, you really can't let them get back in this game. You can't let your foot off the gas. In this game so far, it's been a game of runs. It's been Fordham had a 10-0 run early in the game, then St. Louis went on a 7-0 run. So it seems like for the second half, it's going to be all about who can kind of go on that run to start the half. That's why huge right out the half. I feel like Fordham is going to have to go on a run and kind of take this game away from them.
It's about that pendulum. When it's on your, when the pendulum swings towards you, they got to take care of it, because if Fordham's able to really jump out in this second half and really command with Coach Ergo's mentality, I could see this being, they said this could be our first win in St. Louis.
That's kind of crazy. In nine matchups, that's never having a win in St. Louis is kind of incredible. I know you don't go there every year, but 0-9, that's something you want to look at, you want to break this year, right?
I'm hoping to break that.
Especially for a team that, Miles and Colin mentioned this on the broadcast, a team that's been a road Warriors. They've been struggling at home compared to last year where Rose Thrill, they were dominating at home. It hasn't been like that this year. Coming off a rough loss on Wednesday at home versus Richmond, you really look to get back on track versus this St. Louis team. And going in the second half, what are your keys for the second half to kind of winning this game?
I mean, we talked about already, just distributing the ball to other guys. Kyle Rose is being himself. He's being a stud. There's a reason why he's been at Fordham basketball for the longest out of any longest tenure. And I love him, but if he starts to slip up, I want to see Coach Ergo have the guys dish the ball around. I wanted to see some clean play from the entire team.
Yeah, something I think for the second half is they've been shooting well from inside the paint, but I think they need to stray away from those threes.
Yeah.
When you're shooting not so well for the season, really, or this game, 33% from three, that's when you start blowing those games. You have a 9-point lead, and when you get complacent, start throwing up some threes, that's going to give St. Louis a chance to really get back into this game. I think big key for Fordham in the second half is going to have to get in the paint and get to the line. Only three free throws in that first half. And going 3-for-4, you got to get to the line more in the second half.
They got to fight for those fouls. There have been points where we struggled from the free throw line, but we're back at a point where we're commanding it. And we exude there. We just live there. So, I mean, I'm looking for us to really command it.
And for the second half, they've been super for the second half, they're gonna have to continue to be strong defensively. It's been good defensively so far. I mean, great, 9 steals, forcing St. Louis to turn the ball over 10 times. Anytime you turn a team over 10 times, you're most likely gonna win the game. I know Miles and Colin was saying you don't want to jinx it, but if this game continues the way it's been going, Fordham has dominated so far in this game, and if they kind of keep their foot on the gas, they're just gonna keep going. I could see a big win. I could see a 20-point win, maybe.
If there's a broadcast jinx, I'm going to call Miles, and I'm going to be very, very upset with him. But I don't see that happening. I really just don't want us to go back into our turnover slips because we currently have 11 points off turnovers to their zero. And if we keep that battle going, that's going to be our biggest goal going forward.
Yeah, I think that's huge. Once you start turning the ball over, you kind of get in that. It's just a downhill spiral. You turn
Snowball
the ball
effect.
Over, you let them get back in this game, and that's going to be huge in the second half. You can't let St. Louis come out hot, get back in this game. No. They hit a couple shots, 4 of 8 from three so far, shooting 50%. Who knows, maybe they might come out just hoping, fire away a couple threes, and next thing you know, it's a 2-point game, and you're in a dogfight to end the game. Up 9 at the half, you really kind of have to keep your foot in the gas and keep going.
If they start hucking up threes and this is a close game going down, I would be really scared, because we've lost a lot of games like that this season where it's close throughout the entirety of the game and then we just lose.
Yeah.
That's the thing that I'm most scared for.
Yeah. Once you start throwing up threes and that game gets close, that's when you're going to start turning the ball over. Like we said before, only 2 turnovers from this Fordham team, and they've really been taking advantage of that sloppy St. Louis play. But that is going to be it for us from the halftime show. And after a quick break, we're going to send it back to Miles and Colin in St. Louis. Enjoy the second half.
What's going on, guys? I'm Jack Warner, one of your New York Rangers beat reporters for the 2023-2024 NHL season. I'll have you covered all season long as New York looks to bring a Stanley Cup back to the Big Apple in Peter Laviolette's first season as head coach. Follow me on Twitter at Jack_Warner23 for live game updates, post-game media availability, and all things Blue Shirts.
Hey,
And welcome back inside Chaffetz Arena here in St. Louis, Missouri. I'm Miles Grossman alongside Colin Loughran, and your Fordham Rams lead St. Louis 41-32 at the break. And Colin, these final 20 minutes will be the game of can the Fordham Rams hold on? I mean, they only turned the ball over two times. That was one of the more efficient halves we've ever seen out of the Fordham Rams all year.
And by contrast, St. Louis turned the ball over 10 times. This season, Fordham is 0-7 when they commit more turnovers than their opponent. So it's important that they continue to turn over St. Louis. Additionally, it will be interesting to see who else, if anyone, steps up for Fordham. So far, the story has been primarily about Kyle Rose with the team high 17 points. You've gotten some good play from Ramad Dean and Elijah Gray. We've come to expect that from the sophomores. But I wonder to myself, will Jafay Madur have a burst at some point? Will we see Antrell Charlton find his comfort zone from the mid-range? And on the flip side, if you're St. Louis, do you continue to run the same game plan and try and draw contact and get to the free throw line? So far, 6 of 10 from the charity stripe. They've done a good job of using Ezoero to work him down towards the paint, but they're also the sort of squad that can shoot the three ball when necessary. So far, they've been selective with it. Only 4 of 8 from range, by contrast. Fordham, 6 of 18 from range, so they're more willing to fire at will. St. Louis, a little bit more careful, but when you have someone like Jimerson on your team, why not use that skill to your advantage? And they may have to if they want to cut this lead slowly but surely.
And you mentioned those three-point numbers, Colin. St. Louis, 4 of 8 from downtown, and wow, only 8 attempts. That's an extremely, extremely high clip right there. And, you know, it has looked like the freshman medley. He's very comfortable walking the ball up amidst the injury of Michael Mells Jr., the senior guard. And it's easy. His favorite move really seems to be dropping it down low for Ezoero, and that's a really nice outlet to have as a freshman point guard. That big in the right block that you can just rely on down low. The thing that I'm going to focus on for the Fordham Rams, even though they've done a so-so job of it at 16-10 leading the points in the paint, is locking down that paint, right? I think St. Louis is the type of team that can hurt you down low and wants to hurt you down low. Like you said, Colin, they're not this type of Duquesne team that's going to seek out threes, right? They are going to make a living down low, and so far, Ezoero has been that guy in the first half.
I completely agree in terms of locking down the paint, Miles, but if it were that easy as simply saying, let's lock down the paint, I'm sure Fordham would have already done it. This has been a theme over the last couple of games or so, and it's primarily been because they haven't gotten great play from their rim protectors, and in those situations, they've turned to Josh Rivera or Ramad Dean or someone like an Elijah Gray to serve that role when they're not quite built for it. Those guys are all more forwards than a center, and Abdu Simbila has struggled mightily. It becomes a matter of, would you be comfortable putting Yole Akuovo in for an extended period of time? I don't know if Fordham would be comfortable doing that. He was very good against North Texas earlier this year, primarily because he created so much chaos in the painted area in a way that a Ramad Dean, an Elijah Gray, or a Josh Rivera simply can't with their body type and skill set. And moreover, do you really want those three guys serving as the stout rim protector and playing a physical brand of basketball when you still need their points? You still need them to have fresh legs on the offensive end. No one will ever say this, but that type of wear and tear counts. There's a reason why centers focus so much on the rebounding game and not their own scoring game.
Absolutely, and you can take a look at these first half box scores. Yole Akuovo was out there for 3:15, really not that much time. No shot attempts, no box score impacts. And Abdu Simbila, 8:22 out there, but he's also 0-for-2 from the field. I think we saw some improvement in terms of Abdu's defense and rebounding. He has that self-awareness that he seems to be getting back a little bit, but it will be interesting to keep an eye on if Abdu is that normal, comfortable big guy down low. But Colin, I do want to pivot a little bit because the Billikens have won only one game in Atlantic 10 play, and as you touched on early in the broadcast, they won it in comeback fashion. They trailed by 20 right here in this building against St. Joe's in their sole A-10 win. And as they proved that day, I mean, they are a comeback squad. These Fordham Rams got to keep their foot on the gas.
The Bills are not going to go away quietly. And just for my two cents on the matter of Abdu Simbila versus a potential Yole Akuovo breakout game, I would be in favor of putting Akuovo in, primarily because he's wiry. He contrasts what Ezoero is trying to do. Ezoero, a more compact big man. He wants to move his way with his body weight. Yole Akorvo's wingspan might be enough to slow down someone like Azuero.
So the same starting five out there for the Fordham Rams in the second half. As for the first, Elijah Gray, Ramai Dean, the bigs, and then Antrell Charlton had a meeting with Keith Ergo just a couple days and suggested that he give up his very own starting position for Jafay Madore. So Madore back out there coming off the ankle sprain alongside Will Richardson and Kyle Rose in the backcourt.
It's so rare that you see that type of unselfishness at the collegiate level. Of course, collegiate sports changing in more ways than one, players becoming increasingly focused on their own success. So for someone like Antrell Charlton, who deserves to start, to take that sort of approach speaks volumes about his character.
Sure does. But back underway here from St. Louis, here's Hargrove at the top of the key. The motion offense over to Jimerson. Hands off for Medley. Back to Hughes. Right arc three, and he cans it right out the gate. St. Louis back within six now, 41-35, the Fordham lead, just 15 seconds into our second half.
That was SLU's best offensive possession of the day. There was movement off the ball. Nice job of sharing the rock.
Here's Madore, top of the circle, fakes the three. Now probes and dishes right arc. It's Will Richardson. Richardson dribbles between the legs, pulls the mid-range. Jay, and he's nothing but net there. 43-35. Will Richardson gets a deuce for Fordham.
Those are Will Richardson's first points of the day. You gotta believe Fordham would like to see more from him down the stretch.
Medley, the 5'11" freshman, draws two defenders on the Billiken logo. It's Elijah Gray and Richardson, but they'll find Jimerson. Jimerson left side, he dumps it down low. And Ezeuero picking up right where he left off in the first half. An and one opportunity from the left block. 19:05 to play. And it's a 43-37 Fordham lead with one more free throw coming for Bradley Ezeuero.
And Miles, this is precisely what we were talking about. Ezeuero had the advantage on Ramai Dean. With Dean's size, he's not built to handle someone like Ezeuero down there.
So Ezeuero, who made a living at the free throw line in the first half, about to attempt his sixth and seventh of the game as he rattled, pardon me, just a one and one there. Just wrapping up the old-fashioned three-point play, I should say. So he gets the first and only to fall. It's a 43-38 Fordham lead. Here's Will Richardson in the road. Maroons moving right to left on Larry Hughes II. He'll hand off for Jafay Madore, top of the circle. He'll probe and angle over to the right perimeter. Dish it down to Kyle Rose and get it back. It's right arc, Jafay Madore. One dribble with the right hand, crosses over top of the key and whips it over to Will Richardson. Richardson left arc, draws contact. And this one's going to be on the freshman, Sion Medley, 18:41 to play. And a clock stoppage. This one's on the floor, Colin.
And Coach Ergon not happy with his team's play out of the gate here in the second half. Worth mentioning, Antrell Charlton still on the bench. I wonder when we see him. His senior presence has been invaluable for Fordham.
Kyle Rose flips it into Jafay Madore on the Billiken logo. 18:37 to play in regulation. Here's Jafay Madore, the knee-high dribble with the left hand. Crosses over right to left, pulls up the J well short, airballs it out of bounds. Kyle Rose dives out of play for it, but he cannot keep it in. So the Fordham Rams turn it over with 18:29 to play. It's a 43-38 Ram lead.
You can start to see Fordham getting a little bit frantic. The crowd here in St. Louis coming back into the game. Everybody knows this thing could turn on its head in a matter of moments.
Here's Jimerson, hands off for the freshman in Medley at the top of the circle. Medley, the waist-high dribble with the left hand, bounces it left arc as Ezeuero. The big outside on the perimeter curls around and hands off for Jimerson. Jimerson, top of the key, draws two defenders and swings it right arc. Here's Hargrove, dribble drive from the right side, and the righty lay off the glass and down, and St. Louis right back within a sole possession. 43-40, Fordham on top. 17:51 and ticking here from St. Louis. It's Kyle Rose at the top of the key. He'll flip it high and find Will Richardson. Richardson dribble drive from the right side, pulls up on the elbow and kicks it back up top for Elijah Gray. Gray on the A-10 logo, two-hand chest pass over to Ramai Dean. Now Jafay Madore, left side mid-post, dribble drive from the left side, rises and he can't get the scoop to fall. Well short there, and Jimerson pulls down the SLU rebound. Ahead to the freshman in Medley. Medley to Hughes on the left arc. Looking down low for Ezeuero, and Ezeuero can't handle the pass. But Ramai Dean had the last touch, they say. Oh no, they overturned the call. So Fordham does force the turnover with 17:20 to play. They're still on top, 43-40.
And the Rams caught a break there. Ezeuero nearly squeezed the pumpkin, had another easy look at the rim. Slew crawling their way back in. Antrell Charlton back in the game for Fordham, and I think that that is a very smart move from Coach Ergo.
So Antrell Charlton now the waist-high dribble with the right hand as he crosses the timeline. Angles his way to the right side perimeter. Dribble drive from the top of the key, and he draws some contact, and they'll say the offensive foul. Antrell Charlton a little out of control on the dribble drive, and in the heart of the lane, he turns it right back over to St. Louis. It's 43-40. Rams on top, 17:08 to play in regulation.
I question the senior's decision to try and just drive towards the paint there and create something himself. His bread and butter is either using that mid-range territory or facilitating and finding an open teammate. The last couple of offensive possessions for Fordham looked stagnant and slow, not at all how it looked at the start of this game. If anyone could have righted that ship, it was Antrell Charlton on that possession, but instead, Fordham will have to wait a whole nother possession to try and get things right.
For Fordham, a scoreless drought in the last 2 minutes and 19 seconds, and St. Louis back within just 3 points here at home, and you can tell the crowd really starting to get into it, but with 17:08, we'll take a quick break here from St. Louis. Fordham on top, 43-40. You're listening to Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
How's it going, everybody? I'm Lou Orlando.
And I'm Colin Loughran.
And we're two of your main hosts for WFUV Sports' NHL podcast, 5-on-3.
We'll keep you updated on the Rangers, Islanders, Devils, and of course, the Stanley Cup Final.
Home ice for all things NHL, 5-on-3.
And welcome back to St. Louis, Missouri. It's the 20th meeting all time between a pair of classic Jesuit institutions. It's St. Louis and the Fordham Rams, and the Billikens, Colin, they've dominated the series all time. St. Louis, known to be a basketball school, of course, much more than Fordham is. 15-4, they lead the all-time series. And as you touched on earlier, St. Louis has had quite a few talented NBA names grace this program.
Without question, and this game right now has taken a turn to where you understand the pedigree at play. It may not be the case that any of these current Billikens go on to have great NBA careers, but when you come to a place like St. Louis and you play under Coach Ford, you realize that there is a given standard, and they've started the second half brilliantly, shooting 3 of 3 from the field. That is 100%, Miles. It's hard to defend against that if you're Fordham, especially when you're struggling to find a stout rim protector that can step up and fulfill a certain requirement. You saw it earlier, Ezeuero bullied Ramad Dean in the paint. That cannot continue to happen if the Rams have designs on winning this game. If anything, for St. Louis, it proves that that strategy could work at the end of the day, and if they keep pushing that button, eventually they'll like where they are on the scoreboard.
Absolutely. It's an 8-2 run to start the second half for St. Louis here at home, and they control the basketball. Of course, Fordham scoreless the last 2:20. It's a 43-40 Fordham lead. Now the full court pressure is on out of the Fordham Rams. Medley, the freshman, flips it high to Larry Hughes. Larry Hughes across the timeline on the left side. Back to Medley at the top of the circle. Just 15 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Medley, two-hand pass up top for Hughes, looking down low for Hargrove, and Hargrove can't handle the pass. Last touch by the Fordham Rams. That'll stop the clock with 16:48 to play. 10 seconds on the shot clock here for St. Louis. They trail by 3.
And Jameer Tripp in the game for Fordham now. He's listed as a guard, but he gives you some size in the sense that he could potentially be a forward at times when necessary.
Here's Sion Medley, skips in high post for Jimerson. Jimerson finds the curling Hughes, top of the key, 3, no good. In motion off the left side of the iron, and Will Richardson rips down the Fordham rebound. 16:35 to play. Will Richardson on the left side perimeter finds Elijah Gray on the A-10 logo. Back to Josh Rivera, dribble drive the right side, no good, too strong as he skipped through the lane, and Medley rips down the rebound. Ahead to Hargrove. Hargrove has pass picked off by Kyle Rose, and the Fordham Rams take it right back. Ahead to Will Richardson, now a transition affair. Will Richardson, dribble drive, dumps it down low for Gray, and Gray can't hit, but he is fouled. So two free throws coming for the sophomore Elijah Gray. And Colin, the pace has really picked up in the last 30 seconds.
Fordham will have a chance at the charity stripe. That series created by Kyle Rose at the defensive end had a very good play to swipe the ball away from St. Louis. That's exactly what Fordham likes to see from the Maryland senior. We know he brings heart. We know he brings hustle. In a game like this, it could make all the difference, especially with St. Louis starting to find their rhythm offensively.
So Elijah Gray, the Fordham Rams' top free throw shooter, heads back to the free throw line, and the high arcer rattles around and down, make him 2 of 3 from the charity stripe today. That gives Fordham a 4-point cushion at 44-40, 16-14 to play. And now we have our freshman 7-footer out of China, Bruce Zong, checking back in the low post.
And that tells me that Coach Ford knows exactly what he's doing for St. Louis in their offense. Both him and Ezeuero have been switching roles in terms of bringing that screen high and then working it down low.
So nothing but net on the second for Elijah Gray. Here's the full court pressure for the Fordham Rams. They lead 45-40. The freshman Sion Medley crosses the timeline on the left side, flips it to Hughes, and gets it back. Here's Hughes, right arc, back to Medley, two-hand chest pass, some pretty ball movement. Medley gets it back at the top of the circle, 13 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Larry Hughes, dumps it down low for Zong. Zong rises, and it'll be the foul on the floor. Josh Rivera hit the deck, looking for the flop. They're looking for the contact, but it ended up being a flop, and the 7-footer, Bruce Zong, draws the contact, and that'll stop the clock with 15:53 to play in our second half.
Zong has been fascinating to watch because wherever he goes, or when Ezeuero, when he's on the court, wherever he goes, it dictates what happens with the St. Louis offense. If he moves down towards that painted area, St. Louis has gotten a lot more fluidity on the perimeter, but on the flip side, when they move him up towards the top of the key, then they try and work it back down and really shove it towards Fordham's throat and try and put up an easy basket.
So St. Louis, a solid second half so far. They lead 8-4 in the second period, but the Fordham defense has ratcheted up just a little bit, held St. Louis scoreless the last 2 minutes, and they hold on. They lead by 2 possessions. It's 45-40. The Rams on top here from St. Louis, but we're going to take another quick break here from Missouri. You're listening to Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
Hey guys, it's Nick Palmer, your New York Islanders beat reporter for the 2023-2024 NHL season. Tune into my Twitter at NickPalmer55 for live game updates in addition to pre- and post-game analysis. To get updates on all things Isles, follow me as the Blue and Orange try to bring another Stanley Cup championship to Long Island.
Welcome back inside the Chaffetz Arena here in downtown St. Louis, Missouri. Miles Grossman alongside Colin Loughran. And Colin, this has been quite the fun one. We've had the opportunity to call here from St. Louis, Missouri. Fordham on top, 45-40. They've really led through the entirety, but it's been back and forth here in the second half. Fordham led by their largest at 12 in the first half, and St. Louis clawing right back ever so slowly, but ever so surely.
It's been a fun conference game for sure, Miles. A fun atmosphere without question. I will say, whoever's in the Billiken costume today deserves a raise. He's been doing some fabulous work. Staring down officials, staring down the Fordham players. So good job to whoever was given that prestigious honor this afternoon.
And it's a pretty funny costume to boot. It's the all-white helmet, almost. I don't honestly know what a Billiken is. I guess it's a variation of a bird, I'd assume. But that costume looks more like a ghost than anything.
You can add that to the list of mascots that we don't know what they are. I don't know what a Jasper is, and I don't know what a Billiken is either.
Maybe someone can inform us, Colin.
I would love to find out. If anybody knows that happens to be listening, I would love to know what a Billiken is personally.
But here in St. Louis, a couple bodies to my right for sure know as well. Maybe I'll have to ask him at the next media timeout. But here in St. Louis, it's a 45-40 Fordham lead with 15:53 on our clock. Here's the freshman 7-footer Zong back to the basket on the right block. Rises over Abdu with the right, and he's well short there. And Elijah Gray clears the board for the Fordham Rams. Ahead to Kyle Rose as he crosses the timeline on the right arc. Drills behind the back, looking for a teammate now. Skips it high post for Elijah Gray. He finds Richardson. Top of the key three. Will Richardson, no good. Off the right side of the iron, and Medley rips free the Billiken board.
No points there for Fordham, but a nice offensive set. Richardson did a fabulous job moving off ball, got himself wide open.
Larry Hughes out on the right arc, 20 seconds to shoot. His Billikens trail by five here. 15-15 to play second half. Jimerson dribble drive the right side, and it's swatted back. Abdu Simbila picks up his second block of the day ahead to Jameer Tripp, the freshman. Over left arc, it's Kyle Rose. Two-hand overhead pass inside for Abdu Simbila. On the left block, rises with the left hand. He's no good, but Jameer Tripp, the put back, and Hargrove hits the deck, but the bucket falls. It's a 47-40 lead, and we got a clock stoppage, and Terrence Hargrove is grabbing at the nose, and he surely caught an elbow under the bucket. We'll see who it was on. It was either Jameer Tripp or Abdu Simbila, but nevertheless, our refs did not call anything. It's just a made bucket as it stands. It's 47-40. Rams on top with 14:56 to play. And coming off the Hargrove hitting the deck, grabbing the mouth incident, both sides will head to their benches.
Tripp, the freshman, with a veteran play. We were talking about how he gives you a little bit of size and versatility because he's listed as a guard, can also play like a forward at 6'6", 230 pounds. He's put together a sneaky good day, Miles. 2 points, three rebounds. Nothing to really write home about, but it's sneaky good in the sense that when you're a freshman, you're just trying to impact the game any way you can. And in this sort of contest, it shows good awareness from Tripp that he understands that he has to play a little bit more physically. He has to play like a forward in this instance. There's been other times this year where the handles get a little bit sloppy because he's trying to play like a guard.
And we talk about the physicality of Jameer Tripp. There's just so much potential. I mean, at 6'6", 230, he came in at 230 pounds over the course of the year. He surely slimmed down a little bit. But as a freshman at 6'6", when he came in at that weight, if he's able to turn that weight into a little bit more muscle mass, he's going to be a force to be reckoned with in the Atlantic 10 for years to come. I'm excited to see that development of Jameer Tripp. And early on, particularly in non-conference play, his number one thing was getting to the free throw line, using that body to draw fouls and turn it into productive buckets. And throughout conference play, he's done that a little bit less. It'll be interesting to see if he's able to get back to that style.
And it's also a matter of minutes and gaining experience in that sense. But if he's able to turn that weight into muscle, there's no telling just what he could do at this level of the collegiate game. There's a lot of A-10 teams out there that would love to have someone like Jameer Tripp on their team, precisely because he can give you different looks at both ends and he can handle a lot of responsibility at both ends.
So they're actually sending Terrence Hargrove into concussion protocol. He's got to get checked by the team doctors. He wanted to check back on. The refs would not allow him. So he checks off, and Kellen Thames, the backup guard, checks in his spot. The full court pressure on Kyle Rose on Sion Medley. Sion Medley moving right to left, flips it high post to Thames. Thames crosses the timeline right side. Dribble drive in on Jameer Tripp. He pulls up from 15. No good. Off the left side of the iron, and another Abdu Simbila rebound.
Simbila just looking for somewhere to shuffle the ball off to. Got a little bit flustered for a half a second.
Fordham by seven. 14 and a half to play here from St. Louis. It's Will Richardson outside on the right arc. He hands off for Jameer Tripp, the oversized freshman. Back to Kyle Rose on the Billiken logo. Back to the basket. He lobs it down low for Elijah Gray. He's got it on the right block in the contact. See what the foul call is. They'll call the foul on the floor, in fact it is, or pardon me, the jump ball, but the possession arrow keeps it here with the Fordham Rams. So it'll be the baseline inbound for the Fordham Rams in the offensive half. 6 seconds to shoot. Will Richardson flips it high post. Here's Elijah Gray on the A-10 logo. Pulls up, no good on the fadeaway from the left elbow, and a rebound into the hands of Sincere Parker.
It wasn't a bad look for Gray. Had a nice little pump fake, just couldn't rattle it home.
And Parker has his dribble picked off by Jameer Tripp. Ahead to Kyle Rose in transition. Elijah Gray got it. Left arc, he fakes the three. Now back to Rose, top of the key. He fakes the three, pulls it back, skips it. Left arc, Jameer Tripp, left corner three. No good, well short, fighting for his own miss, and he gets fouled.
Gibson Jimerson too aggressive on the over the back, going for the rebound, and Jameer Tripp will earn his Fordham Rams another offensive possession. 47-40, Rams on top, 13:51 to play here from Missouri.
And Tripp misses the initial shot. Who cares? He followed his own shot. He went for the offensive rebound. That's an effort play. That's not about talent. That's not about skill. That's about the will to win. A hustle play from the freshman.
So Will Richardson, the trigger man, under the basket here for the Fordham Rams in their road maroons. Lobs it in to Abdu Sembila in the left corner. Back to the basket. Sembila to Richardson and dishing down low. Sembila catches and gets fouled. And Kellen Thames, the sophomore guard, knew he had the mismatch. Caught up down low and had to commit the contact on Abdu Sembila, as we see Bruce Zong now switches on to him.
Zong and Sembila, an interesting contrast. Zong much lengthier than Sembila. Sembila a little bit more compact for a center, but definitely more muscular, definitely a stronger build to him.
Kyle Rose getting into it with Parker after the whistle. We got Sembila. Dribble drive the left side and the two-hand slam. Abdu Sembila with the exclamation mark and a 49-40 lead for your Fordham Rams on the road. Here's Medley, the freshman at 5'10", top of the circle. He dishes left arc for Sincere Parker. Parker down low for Zong. He's got it on the left block, backing his way in on Abdu Sembila. The turnaround from Zong is too strong, but he draws the contact. And an awfully late whistle will frustrate the Fordham Rams. But two free throws coming for the freshman center, 7'0" out of China, Bruce Zong.
And what a series of events for Abdu Sembila. Gets the big slam dunk, which I'm sure was a sigh of relief. Immediately fouls on the other end. And Coach Ergo spoke to us a couple of times this season about the fact that Abdu Sembila gets dinked with some of those fouls that other centers just wouldn't.
And Zong, no good off the right side of the iron. The Fordham lead will hold at 9, 49-40. It's a Fordham run of 6-0 in the last 3 minutes. And Bruce Zong continues the St. Louis scoreless drought at the free throw line.
And Zong, typically a 47% shooter from the field. Not a guy that gets to the line a whole hell of a lot.
Zong off the front of the iron, an 0-for-2 trip. Elijah Gray clears the Fordham rebound. And Will Richardson to walk it up now in the road maroons, moving right to left on Larry Hughes. Richardson bounces high post. Elijah Gray dumps it down low for Jameer Tripp, and Tripp rises, and they'll call the jump ball. Sincere Parker almost got the block. They call the jump ball, and the arrow going back St. Louis's way. 13:07 to play. It's Billikens basketball. They trail by 9.
I almost think that if Jameer Tripp stayed in the air for a half a second longer and contorted his body in the form of a shot, he may have had a shooting foul there.
Thames looking down low into the lane for Ezeuero. Ezeuero catches the pass at the top of the key and dishes back up top for Hughes. Hughes over left Thames. Left block Thames. Back up top for Churchich. Churchich the three and nothing but net. George Churchich, the backup guard, gets his first bucket of the day. And St. Louis right back within 2 possessions.
And what a time to get your first bucket of the day. The big horn sounds here in St. Louis. Crowd's back in it.
Here's Jameer Tripp going the other way, moving right to left. Dishes back up top for Will Richardson. Will Richardson, the knee-high dribble with the left hand. He's got it on the left arc. Bounces high post for Abdu Sembila. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Sembila looking down low for Gray, and Elijah Gray is fouled on the floor. That'll stop the clock with 12:24 to play here from St. Louis. It's a 6-point advantage for the Fordham Rams and a baseline inbound in the offensive half.
Things are getting chippy between the two sides, and Fordham needs a good offensive possession badly here. Billikens creeping their way back up again.
Elijah Gray, an aggressive move. The floater, no good with the right hand, too strong. And Hughes pulls down the rebound for St. Louis. Here's Larry Hughes into the offensive half, the knee-high dribble. Crosses over right to left, in on Abdu Sembila. The scoop, and it's swatted once again. Will Richardson, a burst of speed, moving right to left in transition, and that's blocked. Churchich picks up the block, and now St. Louis loose the other way, and a two-hand slam, Larry Hughes, and the transition affair continues.
Fordham seemingly slipping away here. They don't have their foot on the gas in the same way they did initially. They're going to have to figure out an effective offensive set.
Richardson outside on the right arc. Declines the pass for Abdu Sembila at the top of the key and bounces it high post. Here's Kyle Rose, top of the circle. Two dribbles with the right hand, now back to the basket. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Top of the key three, Kyle Rose, yes!
Kyle Rose silences the crowd in St. Louis, and the Fordham Rams back up 7, 52-45.
Ice cold shot from Kyle Rose, 20 points on the day.
Sincere Parker, left corner three, he'll pop, and the high arcer is nothing but net. St. Louis with the answer, and they're back within four. 52-48, the Fordham Rams on top, 11:03 to play. And that one lit up this crowd, Colin.
Anything you can do, I can do better. Crowd is excited. The Billiken is excited.
Here's Will Richardson, angles to the right arc, spins around, pulls up from 15. No good off the left side of the iron. St. Louis going for the rebound, and they'll say the last touch is Elijah Gray, and they can't believe the call. And the Fordham Rams get them to overturn it. It was simply the wrong call. One referee said one thing, one referee said the other, but the Fordham Rams will retain the possession coming out of the timeout. But this crowd has just been lit on fire as of late. Colin, we've had the Kyle Rose antics after the three, and then the Sincere Parker left corner three seemed like it was about to hit the rafters. It was so high in the air, but that one really the biggest shot of the day for St. Louis.
Fordham's had a couple of opportunities to put the Billikens to bed, and they just haven't been able to do so. They've allowed them to stay in this ballgame, and that's exactly what we have now, Miles. We have a ballgame on our hands. This one could go either way. Worth noting that St. Louis is very good in close games. They're 4-0 this year in games decided by 3 points or less.
That's a great stat for this moment, Colin. I appreciate you adding that. But it's a 52-48 Fordham lead here from St. Louis. But with that, we'll take a quick break here and send it back to our Rose Hill studios for a scoreboard update with Owen Kelty.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Ninth-ranked Marquette continued to wallop on Georgetown as they have destroyed them with a final score of 91-57. The 25th-ranked TCU Horned Frogs have fought back in their game against the Texas Longhorns. TCU was down by a few at the half, but now, with 3 minutes and 52 seconds remaining, they trail 66-64. Unranked San Diego State is keeping it competitive against 17th Utah State. They have a 26-22 match with 7 minutes and 22 seconds in the first half. The bout between the Virginia Cavaliers and the Clemson Tigers is coming down to the wire. There is a 66-65 game with 6 seconds remaining. And one of the best matches of the day is about to begin as 4th-ranked Houston will face off momentarily against the 8th-ranked Kansas City Jayhawks. We'll have some more Atlantic 10 action kicking off momentarily as well as two teams in the top of the conference will be taking each other on. The Richmond Spiders have a quick drive over to VCU. With one-on-one scoreboard, I am Michael Matuch.
A back and forth second half affair here from St. Louis, Missouri. Your Fordham Rams on top, 52-48 over the St. Louis Billikens. I'm Miles Grossman alongside my partner Colin Loughran. And Colin, these Fordham Rams, the 3-point shot wasn't there to begin. An awfully slow 1-for-8 shooting start from range, but it's picked up ever since. And Kyle Rose is just every time he needs a big shot, he picks one up. 25 minutes, 3 dimes, and now 20 points coming off that made three.
And on the flip side, St. Louis has gotten more aggressive from behind the arc. In the second half, they are 3-of-4 from that territory, 7-of-12 on the game from long range. That's around 58%. They're shooting roughly 55% from the field in general in this second half. They've been highly efficient. Fordham will have to try and slow that down and figure out just how to stifle a Billiken offense that has seemingly found its rhythm.
Well, Jafay Medor will be the trigger man under the basket. The possession stays here with the Fordham Rams. They lead 52-48, but the pass picked off. Kellen Thames, the backup guard, loose in the backcourt, and a two-hand slam right over Elijah Gray. And just like that, St. Louis within two, 52-50.
Coach Ergo lifting his hands, telling his team, stay calm, we're still in this.
And the crowd is on their feet now here at the Chaffetz Arena. It's Ramad Dean back to the basket at the top of the circle. Hands off for Antrell Charlton. He'll skip it right arc. Here's Ramad Dean. Ramad Dean, top of the key, pops the three, and he's money. Nothing but net there for Ramad Dean in a 55-50 Fordham lead.
A huge three from Ramad Dean. 10 points for him now today. At a critical time, picks up a big three.
Here's Hughes. Hands off for the curling George Kirkich, the backup guard. Two-hand chest pass over to Sincere Parker on the left arc. Up top for Ezawero. Ezawero quickly skips it over to Hughes. Hughes on the right arc. 10 seconds on the shot clock. It's Kirkich. Kirkich on the left arc. Fakes the three in on Kyle Rose. 2 seconds on the shot clock. They don't realize, and that'll be the shot clock violation. Moving it around the perimeter, and Bradley Ezawero had no idea the shot clock was dwindling. So St. Louis turns it right back over to Fordham. 9:40 to play, and the Rams already a 5-point advantage, 55-50.
You got to catch some breaks to win A-10 games, and Fordham just caught a momentous break there. If Ezawero had really thought about it, he had an easy dunk or an easy lay-in, decided to move the ball and try and swing it for an open three. So you can overthink your own offense. Sometimes it's better to go with your gut. Ezawero with 13 points would have been better served to just shoot the ball.
So some full court pressure now from St. Louis. Kyle Rose chest pass into Jafay Madur, and he'll walk it up, moving right to left. The knee-high dribble with the left hand. Hand off for the curling Kyle Rose, top of the key. Now chest pass over to Antrell Charlton in the high post. Charlton has his pocket picked, but he regains on the right arc. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Elijah Gray, spins around mid-post, loses control. What's the call? No call is the call. Out of bounds on Elijah Gray, going back St. Louis's way. 9:19 to play in the second half, and Fordham, a two-possession lead, 55-50.
Fordham starting to beat themselves a bit. It's one thing if you miss open shots. It's another thing entirely if you begin to turn the ball over and don't make smart decisions with the ball.
Here's Sion Medley, the freshman guard out of Camden, New Jersey. The knee-high dribble as he leans in and crosses the timeline on Jafay Madur. Kicks right arc, Sincere Parker, the three, and he's got it. Right back within two with St. Louis, 55-53, and Sincere Parker, the JUCO kid, gets it going.
He's come alive now, 9 points for him, 3 rebounds as well. He's made his presence felt in more ways than one this afternoon. His movement has been exceptional.
St. Louis right back within two. Here's Antrell Charlton, top of the key. Bounces for Kyle Rose. Over to Elijah Gray now. Elijah Gray, the dribble handoff, gets it back. Kyle Rose, right arc three, no good, off the right side of the iron, and Bradley is aware. Rips it free. Ahead to the freshman Medley, and the point guard will cross the timeline with 8:30 to play. 55-53, the Fordham Rams on top here from St. Louis. Sion Medley skips it right arc for Sincere Parker. Parker on the right arc. Thought about the three, kicked it down low for the right corner in Thames. Thames pull-up jumper for the 15-footer is money. And all knotted up at 55 now, and Kelly Thames is fired up. And the local kid out of St. Louis got us all knotted up at 55 with 8:12 to play. And Keith Ergo needs the timeout.
And we talk about energy all the time and players that can bring this sort of swagger or style to a team. Kellen Thames has done that. On the scoreboard, he has 4 points, 2 assists, 2 boards. That's not exactly a superstar performance, but what he has brought is an infusion of energy. That's a very easy word that gets balled up into a bunch of other dynamics, but when you see him running down the court and screaming his lungs out, you can't help but get fired up about that. I can only imagine how his fellow Billikens feel after seeing him hit a big shot like that.
Absolutely, and the Fordham Rams on the other side scoreless in the last 2:04. Well, St. Louis has canned their last 5 from the field. It's a 55-all ball game here from St. Louis. 8:12 to play, and you're listening to Fordham Men's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
Hey everyone, I'm Will Grant.
And I'm Chris Persiainen.
And we're two of the hosts for WFUV's very own basketball podcast, Pick and Pod.
Tune in weekly for updates and our takes on the latest around the NBA, as well as exclusive insight from our very own Knicks and Nets beat reporters.
We'll have you covered on everything from all the NBA's latest drama we know and love,
to debating all year long which team will get to lift that golden Larry O'Brien in June.
So don't miss a beat from the hardwood on WFUV's Pick and Pod.
To play here from St. Louis, Missouri, a tie ball game between your Fordham Rams and the St. Louis Billikens.
I'm Miles Grossman. He's Colin Loughran, and these Fordham Rams have dropped their last two. They stand at 3-5 in Atlantic 10 play. It's hard to overstate how much this road win would mean just for them to get back on track.
Fordham needs to win this ball game if they want to get back on track, as you said, Miles. If for no other reason than at one time they thought they were these road warriors, you could still salvage that sort of narrative if you're able to win this game. For St. Louis, they've been playing a good team game of basketball. You could look at the stats, you could look at who stepped up. As Aguero with a team-high 13 points, but really, they have four guys with 5 points or more. That's a winning recipe, and it shows me that they're sharing the basketball. 12 assists so far today, Fordham with 12 assists as well, but the Rams have struggled as of late to really get going offensively. They've begun to beat themselves, and they just haven't shot the ball as well in the second half. And in that second half, shooting at roughly 29% from the field.
And taking a look at that St. Louis box score. Hughes up to 10 points. Hargrove up to 11. And Ezeuero down low with 13. That's really the three-headed monster so far for Sincere Barker. Tacking on a couple threes of his own here in the second half. Here's the full court pressure for St. Louis. Fordham to inbound. Here's Will Richardson to move right to left. He crosses the timeline on the far side on Sion Medley. Hands off for Antrell Charlton. Right side perimeter. Bounce pass high arc. It's Kyle Rose. Kyle Rose, the lob into Josh Rivera. Josh Rivera back to the basket, rises through contact, and he draws it. No finish with the right hand, but he will be headed to the free throw line. And Josh Rivera, the Old Ridge, New Jersey native, who was quite solid at working his way to the free throw line, does it again.
His favorite spot on the court, Miles. Of course, Josh Rivera has struggled from the charity stripe this season. It's been one of the talking points surrounding this Fordham team, but no time like the present to right the ship.
So Josh Rivera at the free throw line, and the high archer is nothing but net, and that's got to feel good for the sophomore, making a 56-55 Fordham lead. Josh Rivera, one of one from the charity stripe today. Just a 40% on the campaign, but make it 2-2 there. And a 57-55 Fordham advantage.
The little things add up over the course of a game. You may have just saw two huge free throws.
George Kirkish got it on the right arc. 7:42 to play here from St. Louis. It's a 57-55 Fordham lead. Medley, top of the circle. He'll bounce it left elbow for Kellen Thames. Thames back to the basket, skips it right arc. Here's Sincere Barker. Barker back to Thames. Right corner three. He rises. He's no good. Well strong there, but he gets his own miss. Antrell Charlton pokes it free into the hands of Josh Rivera, and Fordham finally wraps up the possession.
Thames nearly got an offensive rebound and another look at the basket. Fordham with a nice job to box him out and get to the rock first.
7:10 to play here in the second half, 57-55. The Fordham lead. Josh Rivera left arc, and he traveled with it as he lost the basketball out of bounds. Kellen Thames forces the Fordham turnover with 7:07 to play.
And Rivera was on the left block at that point. He has no business dribbling the ball at that specific spot on the court. Just rise up and take the shot if you have it.
Churchich crossing the timeline on the near side. The big and Abdu Simbila switches onto him. Kirkic on the right arc, two-hand underhand pass into the hands of his freshman Medley. Medley spins around, dribble drive, loses control. Kyle Rose fighting for it. It's a scrum. Will Richardson in there with Thames, and they'll call the jump ball with the possession arrow going the Fordham Rams way. 6:41 to play in the second half, and the Fordham Rams force a big stop right there. They lead 57-55 with the basketball now.
And I believe it was Will Richardson who ended up with the ball. He's had a rough day, 2 points, two assists, three rebounds only, but to make a hustle play like that speaks about what this Fordham team is trying to accomplish, and it tells you that they understand the stakes.
And that's that Fordham brand. That's that Ergo brand, if you will, Colin. Right here in St. Louis, they seem to be getting back to it. 6:41 to play, and a narrow two-point advantage. Here's the full court pressure out of St. Louis. Kyle Rose fakes the pass into Richardson, gets it into Antrell Charlton in the backcourt. 6:40 to play now. Charlton crosses the timeline, the knee-high dribble with the left hand. Crosses over, moving left to right, pulls up from 15. The mid-range Jane, no good, too strong. Off the heel, and Kellen Thames, another St. Louis rebound.
Ahead to Sion Medley, and we got a timeout out of Travis Ford. It's a 57-55 Fordham lead, and St. Louis now wants the timeout with 6:23 to play.
That's a tactful timeout from Travis Ford. You have a chunk left in this second half. You want to talk to your team down two and not let the Fordham lead balloon.
Absolutely, Colin. And Travis Ford, he's a veteran head coach, right? Year 8 here at the program. Before that, stops around the A-10, stops at some bigger schools, coming off that stint at Oklahoma State. But Travis Ford, in his 8 years here, he's never had this slow of a start to Atlantic 10 play. And you can almost feel the energy, feel the desperation coming off the Billikens, right? When you see Kellen Thames play, that kid wants it. This is a group that's 1-7 in Atlantic 10 play. They've lost a couple tight ones, but the passion is really there, and that passion comes really from one place, the built-up frustration of a continued losing streak into A-10 play.
And you know that that starts with Ford. Through one way or another, he's a guy that expects a lot of his players. We talked about his blue-chip DNA earlier. This is also a guy that has made 7 total NCAA tournament appearances as a coach on the whole. He wants to win. He's about a winning culture. So when you're not playing up to par, you better believe he's going to find a way to make you play up to his standard.
And this St. Louis Billiken team today, very efficient from three-point range, 8 of 14, well north of 50% from downtown, 20 of 41 from the field. And the Fordham Rams have done a good job getting their looks. They're just not as efficient, and that's kind of been the theme as the last few games have gone. I mean, 21 of 57, 8 of 25, they're up narrowly. But they're going to need to pick those numbers up in the final 6:23.
And the way the Billikens have played is the way that many basketball purists would tell you the game is supposed to be played. It's not supposed to be a high-volume three type of fiasco. It's more of look for your spots, try to get to places on the court where you maximize your chances to win.
6:23 to play here from St. Louis. We had a little word from Keith Lurgo into our crowd mic there. I wasn't even sure what he said, but we hope you heard it home. It's a 57-55 lead for the Fordham Rams. Here's Sion Medley, left side short corner. He'll bounce it inside for Bradley Ezeuero. Ezeuero back to the basket, in on Abdu Simbila, rises from the left block, and he gets it to fall off the window and in, and it's a 57 all ball game, tied with 6 minutes flat to play here from Missouri.
Abdu Simbila has had a better second half than it was his first half. Another example there with a big shot.
Here's Josh Rivera, dumps it down low for the cutting Kyle Rose, and they'll have the goaltend. Bradley Ezeuero was awfully close to the block. Our near side referee says goaltend, and the deuce will count for the Rams. It's now 59-57, 5:51 to play. Here's the freshman Sion Medley, the undersized point guard, angles his way to the right side perimeter on Will Richardson, bounces down low for Bradley Ezeuero. Bradley Ezeuero muscling his way through Abdu, and he's too strong there, and Will Richardson the rebound. Ahead to Josh Rivera, they've got one on three, and Josh Rivera will draw the contact. This is on Sincere Parker in transition, but the Fordham Rams now, the squad in the bonus here in the second half. So a 1-1 coming for Josh Rivera. The Rams on top, 59-57. Colin narrowing in on crunch time, only 5:33 to play.
And being in that bonus, a beautiful place to be, assuming you can make your free throws. It all comes back to, can you do the little things right? Hitting your free throws, chief among those small things that matter in close ball games. We've spoken about how good the Billikens are in these sort of contests. The Rams have to maximize their ability to win. Make your free throws.
And Josh Rivera, 2 of 2 from the charity stripe today. He's only a 41%er on the campaign. He faces that St. Louis bench. The high archer is no good off the heel. Kyle Rose got the rebound, and the deuce counts. He'll call the basket interference, but at the moment, the bucket will count. And a referee says we'll look at it at the next media timeout. So they will put the bucket. I was correct. So we see the 61 go up there on the scoreboard. Fordham Rams up 61-57. Kyle Rose credited with the tip in following the missed free throw. And our referees give him the bucket, say we'll take a look at it at our next stoppage. At the moment, 61-57. And now St. Louis moving left to right in their home whites. Here's Hughes back to the basket on the Billikens logo. It's Kyle Rose applying the pressure. Flips it high post for Thames. Thames at the top of the key. Angles around and hands off for Jimerson. Jimerson
Back to Hughes. Hughes on the left side to Jimerson. Left arc three from Jimerson. No good. Well short. He's been ice cold today, and they can't corral the rebound. Sincere Parker, the last touch as it dribbles out of play on the baseline. And the Fordham Rams will take over the possession. They lead 61-57. 5:10 to play.
That's a shot that Jimerson normally sinks. Fordham catching a break here and there. Those breaks add up. Jimerson with a wide open look from the corner.
Josh Rivera catches the inbound pass from Kyle Rose and beats the full court pressure by handing off to Will Richardson. Richardson across the timeline as he holds five fingers in the air. It's the knee-high dribble with the left hand. He'll bounce it left elbow. Now Josh Rivera spins around, hands it off for Kyle Rose. The left side triple, no good. And right into the hands of Larry Hughes there, now moving left to right. Larry Hughes, the rebound, two-hand overhead, skip pass, and it's out of play. Will Richardson just got a piece of it. It was going out of bounds whether he touched it or not, and a tough break there for the Fordham Rams as St. Louis will retain the possession. Fordham on top by 61-57, 4:45 to play.
That's a sophomore mistake. Better to let it go, especially if you realize it's going out of bounds. Perhaps it was just a matter of perception or the idea that he could have stole the ball and created a break on the other end, but nevertheless, St. Louis with a chance here to trim Fordham's lead further.
So Terrence Hargrove, who seemed to have cleared concussion protocol, has just checked in for the first time in quite a while. He'll hand off up top for Larry Hughes. He's got it on the right side perimeter. Kyle Rose, the pressure is a loose ball into the hands of Zong. Zong got it right side mid post. 9 seconds on the shot clock. He bounces it in the hands of Charlton, and Charlton can't handle it as it bounces out of play on the baseline. And once again, with 7 seconds on the shot clock, this possession staying here with the Billikens.
And Zong got the basketball and didn't know what to do with it. He didn't want to shoot it. He didn't want to pass it. He just froze there for a half a second. So inexperienced, and it's showing here in the late stages.
And Zong has it on the right side, and they can't get the pass to him. Larry Hughes looking for the lob into Zong, and it goes out of play right into the St. Louis bench. So the Fordham Rams force a turnover with 4:29 to play and a four-point advantage. They got the basketball now.
St. Louis showing press with just over four, as you mentioned, Miles. Fordham will have to figure something out.
Kyle Rose, the baseball pass ahead to Josh Rivera. Rivera jump stops, rises, and he's got the layup. The lefty lay falls, and Fordham extends the lead to six now, 63-57. Here's the Billikens. Larry Hughes, top of the key, burst of speed, in on Abdu, and Abdu, the rejection out of play. Abdu Simbila, the defensive menace, is having quite the afternoon now. The possession will stay right here with St. Louis, but that's got to be a minimum of three on the day for Simbila.
Now there's the Abdu Simbila that Fordham fans have known for the last 4 years. You know that when he's blocking shots like that, he's starting to figure things out.
4:15 to play. Here's Jimerson, left side forecourt. He finds his freshman point guard in Medley. Medley burst of speed, drives through the lane, and Abdu Simbila swats it off the glass, but the offensive rebound, Hargrove, and the skip through finish off the window and in. Abdu picks up the block, but Terrence Hargrove resilient, and that'll bring St. Louis back within four. It's 63-59, 3:52 to play.
We knew the Billikens were not going to go away quietly. They're putting up a fight.
Josh Rivera on the left arc. Tries to catch the bounce from Kyle Rose. He just barely saves it in play. Kyle Rose, two-hand overhead pass. Santrell Charlton, right arc three. He's well strong there as he just grazes the rim. And Sincere Parker, a burst of speed into the offensive half. St. Louis trails by four with 3.5 to play. Dribble drive and a Sincere Parker two-hand slam. And Parker, who missed the first 11 of the year, is a big part of this St. Louis team. Brings them right back within two.
Parker with such impressive vertical. He's 6'3", 195 pounds, just rose up for the slam.
And Josh Rivera looks to be hurt. He's holding out his nose. Looks like he got knocked in his nose, and he looks like he is having some stomach issues as well. Kyle Rose had this happen to him a few weeks ago, but we got Josh Rivera rushing over to the trash can behind us. He is hurling in the trash can as we speak. But we got a timeout at a key third, as he could tell the nausea was setting in on Josh Rivera's face. He quickly whistled for the timeout, and now both sides in their respective huddles. The Fordham Rams, the basketball, and a two-point lead. They lead 63-61, 3:11 to play.
And Keith Thurgood gave Kyle Rose a lot of props when he hurled mid-game on the road because it showed the effort. And once again, it's a similar thing. Josh Rivera showing off that effort.
I suppose this is now a working hazard of being a Fordham Ram with that culture of running up and down and doing all the wind sprints and showing that hustle. You're going to have some stomach issues from time to time, I suppose. But we sincerely hope Josh Rivera is okay. His size and athleticism have made such a big difference in the last couple minutes. I mean, you saw that reverse lay he had earlier, a big shot at a crucial time.
And I think many of us have been there, Colin Loughran. When you overexert yourself athletically, there's not even a reason prior to the athletic event for the throwing up. It's just you overexert yourself, maybe too much trust in your ability to regain your lungs. And I mean, it's funny to see this twice in one season. Keith Thurgood is the kind of coach that gets the most out of his players.
And that speaks to what emotions he's able to evoke. A lot about coaching at the collegiate level is not so much about crafting skill, it's about crafting mental toughness. You think about some of the great coaches in NCAA history, Coach K, Coach Roy Williams, someone like John Calipari. Sure, those guys had gifted players, but all of them were able to invoke emotions that brought the most out of those players. I mean, especially someone like Coach K, local kid Jason Tatum went to Duke. He recounts multiple stories about how hard Coach K was on him individually during practices and how it motivated him to work harder and harder, and eventually ended up in the NBA, now a great player with the Boston Celtics.
I hear you. And, you know, in the case of Keith Thurgood, it's funny because it's easy to get the most out of your guys when you're winning ball games. But when you start to lose, right, back-to-back losses in Atlantic 10 play, that's where the effort might be put into question, but not at all with this group of Fordham Rams. They seem like they could lose every single game and give Keith Thurgood everything they have and more, and that's part of the reason why the bond between Urgo and Rivera has become so special, and maybe they're just 6 or so months together.
And it speaks to the gauntlet that is A-10 play. It is a long season. We're still a month away, just about, from tournament play, from the Barclays Center, from the big lights, and we know what happened last season for Fordham. They won a game against LaSalle. They put up a hell of a fight against Dayton. We don't know what's going to happen this year, but it's a long way to go until we get there, and every game could be used as a stepping stone. I think Coach Ergo is someone that understands that. I think his guys have bought into that mentality that one game is not going to kill us or rise us to the top of the ranks.
And zooming out on this game a little bit as a whole, the Fordham Rams led at the break 41-32 on the road in St. Louis. But these St. Louis Billikens have charged all the way back. They lead 29-22 in the second period. And of course, they trail by just a pair of points now. Josh Rivera has been subbed out. So the five out there for the Fordham Rams: Antrell Charlton, Kyle Rose, Will Richardson, and then the starting bigs, and Elijah Gray and Ramad Dean. So it'll be interesting to see if Rivera is good to go in a few moments. Of course, we only got 3:11 to play.
And I wonder if we're going to see something, anything, from Gibson Jimerson down the stretch. He has been really quiet. He's the Billikens' leading scorer this season. Only 3 points, 2 assists, 2 rebounds. He's done a nice job facilitating, but that's not necessarily what he's here to do. He is here to score the basketball, and in a tight game, you need all the points you can get from your top guy.
And Jimerson has been the St. Louis leading scorer for 3 straight seasons, this year at 15.3 points per game. But you're exactly right. He was the number one name on that scouting report, and the Fordham Rams have dealt with him in years past. They're shutting him down today here at home. So back underway here from Shavitz Arena. It's a 63-61 Fordham advantage. Here's Kyle Rose near arc. He'll flip in high post for Antrell Charlton. Over right arc now, Will Richardson. Two-hand overhead pass inside from Elijah Gray. And Elijah Gray smokes the scoop lay. Much too strong there. And Hughes rips it free for the Billikens.
It was a physical try from Fordham. I like the aggression trying to pound the inside part of the paint.
Zion Medley probes at the top of the key, dishes back up top for Jimerson. Jimerson flips it back now. Here's Medley on the right arc, 13 seconds to shoot. Medley dribbles between the legs, Will Richardson the pressure. Medley, the freshman, dribble drive, pulls up on the right elbow. He gets caught up, he scoops it in as the shot clock expires. It's a 63 all ball game, 2.5 to play.
And Medley waited and waited and didn't rush a thing. He gets rewarded with an easy 2 points.
63 all is Kyle Rose over to Antrell Charlton at the lefty slot. Charlton fake the three, now dishes back up top. Elijah Gray, high arcing three around and no good. All the way around the rim, and Sion Medley will walk it up now for St. Louis, and they need a timeout. Travis Ford wants to regroup on the sidelines as his Billikens have charged all the way back. It's a tie ball game with 2:04 to play.
And this is part of the chess match. Coach Ford knows that the crowd is officially back into this game, permanently so, with just over 2 minutes to play. He wants his guys to be cool, calm, and collected on the next offensive possession. A three, a two, any basket, however you can get it, changes the game and makes Fordham have to play from behind at least momentarily. You cannot discount the fact that this possession could dictate the pace the rest of the way.
So 2:04 to play here from St. Louis, Missouri. And the Billikens, 31-22, they lead this second half in a 63-all ball game, and Colin, a 6-0 run for the Billikens in the last minute 57. Early on, it was a slow shooting start for both squads. St. Louis in particular just couldn't get anything going, but Sincere Parker came in off the bench. Terrence Hargrove and Bradley Ezeuero really held it down in the low post, and they have slowly but surely climbed their way back into this one. It's a 0-0 ball game with 2:04.
And the shooting in the second half has been phenomenal on the part of the Billikens.
So Sion Medley across the timeline on the Billiken logo, moving left to right. Angles his way to the right side perimeter, picks up the dribble now with Abdu Simbila on him. 14 seconds to shoot, he finds Sincere Parker. Parker outside on the right arc, it's Antrell Charlton applying the pressure. Parker looks inside, can't handle the ball, but he bounces it off the legs of Elijah Gray. Caught himself in the air on the baseline, bouncing off the legs of Gray, and he'll stay right here with St. Louis. 6 seconds on the shot clock in a tie ball game. 1:45 to play here at home for the Billikens. Hargrove, top of the circle. Will Richardson applying the pressure. Hargrove spins around, dribble drive. It's swatted out of play by Kyle Rose. With 2 seconds on the shot clock, it dribbles out of play. So stays right here for the Billikens, but only 2 seconds to shoot now.
And Hargrove realized Rose was guarding him, tried to draw contact, a smart play, but it did not work in his favor. Rose with such good positioning on the block.
Sion Medley, the freshman trigger man, under the basket. 1:41 to play. 2 seconds on the shot clock here. Medley dishes left arc. He finds Jimerson. Jimerson will pop the three. No good. And the offensive rebound. Bradley Ezeuero will draw the contact. And this one's going to be on the floor. The Fordham Rams still 2 fouls shy of the bonus. It'll just be the near sideline inbound for St. Louis. Still a tie ball game, 63-all with a minute 37 to play.
And once again, Jimerson with a wide open, clean look from the corner, just couldn't bury it. Ezeuero saves his bacon in that instance.
So a lengthy possession for the Billikens here with the basketball in the hands of the freshman, Sion Medley, once again under the basket. He's the right side trigger man. Over to Jimerson. Jimerson, top of the key, tries to find Hargrove, and Terrence Hargrove has his pass picked out of play. Elijah Gray will have the last touch. 17 seconds on the shot clock, 94 seconds to play here in the second half. We got a tie ball game. Colin Loughran, 63-all in St. Louis, has retained the basketball for nearly a minute, it feels like.
And I wouldn't be surprised if we see something drawn up for Sincere Parker at some point. He's been deadly today with the basketball, so shifty in terms of his handles.
Medley leans in on Will Richardson at the top of the key, dribbles between the legs, angles himself to the right arc. Caught up on the right arc, he'll hand off for Sincere Parker. Dribble drive in the 10-foot fadeaway for Sincere Parker. Nothing but net there, and a 65-63 St. Louis lead.
Parker with just a small dribble, steps back, hits the mid-range.
Elijah Gray has got it on the left side perimeter. Hands off for Kyle Rose, fakes the three on the left arc. Kyle Rose, knee-high dribble, spins around at the top of the key, finds Antrell Charlton. Antrell Charlton, 10 seconds to shoot. Charlton fades, and he's got his pass poked free. But Kyle Rose, the offensive rebound, he drives in and he draws contact. So 2 free throws coming for Kyle Rose. And he got smacked with 5 seconds on the shot clock. But he will now walk up to the free throw line in a raucous environment. 49 seconds to play. The Fordham Rams trail by 2, 65-63, with 2 opportunities at the charity stripe for their veteran, Kyle Rose.
The Rams lucky to be in the bonus. Rose at the free throw line. Of course, it looked as if he was trying to dump that ball off. You have to go for the shot, especially when you're already in that bonus and you need the points.
So Kyle Rose, a big free throw. The lefty veteran is nothing but net. earns himself the second free throw. And brings the Fordham Rams within just 1 point. It's 65-64. St. Louis on top with 49 seconds to play. There's one more free throw coming out of the left hand of the veteran Kyle Rose. He's already got 25 on the day. Bends the knees and he's calm, cool, collected. And a 2-2 trip ties us up at 65 all. 46 seconds to play here from Chavez Arena. It's the freshman, Sion Medley, top of the key. He finds Sincere Parker, dribble drive. Sincere Parker out of control. Loses the basketball, and Elijah Gray comes down with it. Will Richardson will cross the timeline. Key third goal wants the timeout, and the Fordham Rams will have it. Both sides to the bench here. 65-all is the score with 31.3 to play. Of course, it is Fordham Ram basketball. And the St. Louis crowd unhappy that they did not get the foul call when Sincere Parker drove on the previous possession.
It's an intelligent timeout call from Coach Erdogo as well. I like the fact that he let some clock wind down because now 6 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. If you're able to get it all the way down, that would leave SLU about roughly 6 seconds to get a shot off. Even if they were to call a timeout, with the way this game has been with stoppages and some back and forth, they would have to have one great offensive set to get off something clean. Important that Fordham draws up something just as effective here. You don't want to have it come down to a final shot and have SLU have a wide open Jimerson or someone to that regard nail it in your face.
And the crowd here at Chaffetz Arena is now on their feet. Pretty much the entire crowd awaits this next possession. 31.3 to play here in the second half. 65 all is your score. The Fordham Rams will have 25 seconds on the shot clock. And Colin, this is a Fordham team that led by 42-31 at the break. And now, 41-32. And now, of course, that lead has been gone into the wind. But they'll look to hold on.
The lead has evaporated for sure, Miles. Fordham led for almost 35 minutes worth of this game. It's surprising that the game has been as close as it's been down the stretch. It's a credit to the way that the Billikens have shot the basketball in the second half. They've gotten some key performances from some different players. Ezeuero, Hargrove Jr., Medley, of course. But also, Sincere Parker has been very good for them. Even someone like Zong, where he hasn't been great on the stat sheet, he's taken up space, and that's allowed their offense to do a lot and move more freely and more fluidly.
So a tie ball game, it's 65-65. Kyle Rose, the far sideline inbounder here in St. Louis, Missouri. Rose already up to 26 points on the day. The chest pass into Antrell Charlton. About a 5 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Antrell Charlton stands at the far side forecourt. No dribbles yet. No pressure from Jimerson neither. He starts the dribble with the left hand. Knee-high dribble with the left hand, Antrell Charlton works his way to the left elbow, draws the defender, finds Will Richardson, left side three, well short. Out of bounds, last touch, it'll be Billikens had the last touch. Bradley Ezeuero reached over the back of Will Richardson, tapped it out of play, and with 6.5 seconds, the Fordham Rams look to have just earned another possession and what should be the final possession in a 65-all ballgame.
And that's the ultimate testament to just how important it is to work the offensive glass. We can talk about defensive rebounding until the cows come home, but in this sort of situation, you have to crash the glass after an attempted shot. If Fordham didn't race towards the basket, specifically I believe it was Kyle Rose who got the offensive board, we're used to that from him. If it wasn't for him, St. Louis has an opportunity to win the game with about 6.5 seconds on the clock. So Fordham with a hustle play that gives them new life and a chance to avoid overtime.
And it was a great play there, a great effort play by Kyle Rose just to get his feet down there. Bradley Ezeuero had to fight for the ball. He tapped it out of play. And Colin, it looked clear as day to my eyes that Bradley Ezeuero had the last touch. I'm fairly confident that the Fordham Rams will retain the possession. 65-all is the score with 6.5 seconds to play. We hear about Deuces Wild. You ever hear about 6.5?
That's certainly a new one, Miles, and my head immediately goes to Who's taking the last shot? Who do you trust to take the last shot in this specific ballgame? And at the collegiate level, it could be about who has the hot hand. And Kyle Rose has had the hot hand today. I would not be surprised at all if Fordham looks to him. There are, of course, other options that you're trying to figure out something on a pick and roll. You could see someone like Abdu Simbila end up with the basketball right under the rim. It wouldn't be at all surprising. We know he had a buzzer beater earlier this season against North Texas. Everything up for grabs in this game. You have an opportunity to win it, to put yourselves back on the right path. St. Louis must be sweating a touch. They don't want to drop a home game against a team that's been struggling just as much as they have.
And if you're the Fordham Rams, you got to handle this correctly. You got the basketball in a tie ball game with 6.5 seconds to play. And you really got to keep in mind, don't give St. Louis an opportunity, right? It doesn't matter if you score here, but worst case, the Fordham Rams are going to have to force overtime. You hold the shot for triple zeros. I mean, if they get rid of it, that's a mistake.
And make it a clean look. You don't want to have a situation where you just chuck it up. And if you do, you'd rather have it be from the perimeter where something's negotiable. You could work a shooting foul up there. Refs sometimes get a little bit whistle-happy in these type of situations. If you work someone off the screen and he's got a three-point look with someone right on him, you may draw contact and get to the line. You could win the game that way. The point is, you have to get creative here.
So the call does stand. The crowd groans in unison, and the basketball will stay here with the Fordham Rams. They add 0.3 seconds onto the game clock here. Of course, the shot clock is long over here in regulation. 6.8 seconds to play. It's a tie ball game, 65-all, between the St. Louis Billikens and your Fordham Rams. The Fordham Rams will have the basketball. It's Kyle Rose, the trigger man, under the basket. 6.8 to play in a game-winner situation here from St. Louis. Kyle Rose flips it high into the hands of Elijah Gray. Back to the basket. Fades away. The high archer is nothing but net. Elijah Gray buries it. 2.2 seconds to play, and the double dribble by Hughes, and they got the timeout in time just before the double dribble. With 0.7 seconds on the clock, Travis Ford, the head coach of St. Louis, saw what was unfolding, and he called the timeout. It was a pretty clear, sincere Parker double dribble in the back half. And now the question is, will they call the turnover with 0.7, or did Travis Ford get the timeout in?
Well, first of all, can we give credit where credit is due? What a fadeaway shot from Elijah Gray. I don't know if we've seen him hit a fadeaway like that at any point this year. Supreme confidence to take that shot in the first place and then to sink it in the fashion he did. Incredible play from the sophomore.
And Elijah Gray has just really strung together a special few weeks. He picked up his fourth career start today. And Elijah Gray, the kind of guy in his sophomore campaign that seems to be the future of the Fordham Rams front court.
He's progressed nicely this year, and you look at what he's able to do. He can score at all three levels, and in some ways, he's able to score more easily at the harder levels. His three-point shooting has come along nicely. He can hit a mid-range shot, as he just showed seconds ago. The last part of his game is working on that inside territory, becoming more physical, and even that's an uphill climb because you don't know if you want him to lean in that direction. You don't know if his skill set will really lend itself to that at the collegiate level. But nevertheless, all those discussions aside that we'll be having for the next couple of weeks, months, potentially years, a critical shot from Elijah Gray. Fordham with a chance to steal another win on the road, a much needed win on the road, especially after the last couple of games and how heartbreaking they've been.
A special fadeaway out of the right hand of Elijah Gray. You could just see with 2.2 seconds, he faded away left side mid post. And that was not an easy shot. Elijah Gray didn't even make it easy on himself. And what's interesting about that shot, Colin, if it doesn't go, there's still 2.2 seconds to play. It's arguably an ill-advised shot. But, of course, the ends justify the means. And Elijah Gray, a very solid two-point fadeaway to give the Fordham Rams a 67-65 lead with 0.7 seconds. Yes, just 0.7 of a second here from St. Louis. It was a wild sequence coming off the made bucket. St. Louis decided to immediately inbound it right into the hands of Sincere Parker. He double dribbled, but just mere seconds before the double dribble, Travis Ford on the other side gets the timeout in. So with 0.7 to play, will be one more opportunity for the St. Louis Billikens trailing by two.
And assuming St. Louis gets the basketball, your mind immediately goes to what's the play going to be? With this amount of time on the clock, do you go for a tip-in? Do you go for a quick release from three or from anywhere you can get it on the court? It's an interesting scenario for Coach Ford. I'm not sure if there's a textbook on how to run a play with this amount of time on the clock, especially at this level where guys aren't necessarily flying towards the hoop and dunking at home all the time.
You know what the situation is now for the Fordham Rams? This is don't foul time, Dunk.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You
really,
have to
if you don't
clean.
Foul, you have to assume that the Fordham Rams will escape. Of course, 0.7, you could have a magical 3/4 court heave. But you leave St. Louis that opportunity. You don't commit the foul. Under a second to go, and the Fordham Rams, barring a heave from St. Louis, will escape victorious. And the Fordham Rams, after leading through the first 20, seemed like they were down and out. Then Elijah Gray, at the moment, the hero of the day.
And I like the word escape, Miles. Fordham led for the vast majority of this game. They played some good basketball at times, but there were other instances where they got too sloppy. They weren't careful enough. So escape is precisely the right word. You feel good about this win, but you could have felt a lot better had you stayed consistent.
So they'll add 0.5 seconds to the clock, Colin. That is quite a bit of time. So 1.2 seconds to play. It's St. Louis Billikens basketball, two hands extended for Abdu Simbila.
And I believe the Billikens are out of timeouts. They'll have to advance it from behind half court.
So they're in the defensive half. Terrence Hargrove is the inbounder. Abdu Simbila, the arms extended. 1.2 to play. The Fordham Rams up by two. Sincere Parker, left arc. He pops, and he's no good. Off the right side of the iron. It had a chance. It does not fall. And the Fordham Rams make the trip west to St. Louis. And after their back-to-back losses in 8-10 play, pick up a big win on the road. 67-65, and Elijah Gray, the fadeaway from 10 feet with 1.2 seconds will be the shot the Fordham faithful remember after this one.
And this thing came down to the very last seconds, Miles. You mentioned that last shot. Sincere Parker, not by definition a three-point shooter, but did a nice job creating some degree of separation to get the shot off in the first place. It was going to be a tough angle no matter what he did. Nevertheless, Fordham escapes with another road win. They're becoming quite the road warriors. They do have that one loss on their road resume against Duquesne, but you start to like the fact that the camaraderie is there. Whenever they travel, they seem to bring a certain level of intensity that is noticeable.
And Kyle Rose sets a new career high at 26 points. He set a new career high just three games ago at 24. But man, the veteran just gets better day in and day out. And the Fordham Rams, a 67-65 win over the St. Louis Billikens.
And they've needed Rose's scoring. It's not a given that you're going to get a 20-point outing, a 15-plus point outing from someone like a Jafe Maduro or an Antro Charleston. So to have Rose step up and score in the way that he has been able to do lately, critical for Fordham.
And we're now joined by assistant coach Ron Ramon. Coach, thank you so much for your time. An unbelievable win, 67-65. Passion from the tip all the way to the final whistle. I mean, Kyle Rose sets a new career high with 26 points today. It seems, you know, he's played in 130 games as a Ram, and he's still getting better.
Yes, yes. I'm going to tell you what. Kyle had a great night offensively, but it's defensively one of our best nights as a team. Kyle himself led the team, making sure we pressure, making sure we execute defensively. When we play that way, our offense just flows. So I think tonight, you know, it's a testament to what they did. The outcome didn't matter to us. I'm going to be honest. Obviously, it feels good to go home with a win, but the way those guys played tonight and everything that they did, the unity of the team, how well they played together, executing defensively, I think it says a lot about the team.
So I have to ask, Elijah Gray breaks out the fadeaway. Has he been working on that one in practice? Because I'm not sure I've ever seen him hit it with that much precision.
Elijah's a confident guy, you know. We went to Elijah. We knew he was going to make a play either way, and he just ended up making the shot, you know. But I think defensively he played one of his best games, being able to guard those talented guards that they have. You know, my hat off to St. Louis. They got a great team. They are fighting in every single game. They're in every single game. They make runs at a time. You know, they made a 14-0 run against Dayton. They were down 20 against St. Joe's, coming back and win. And tonight you can see that the talent that they have is there. So I know they're doing a great job over there as well.
And Abdu Sambila, he's had an up and down last couple weeks. Today his defense just unbelievable, swatting every shot that came in his range. I mean, what'd you see out of Abdu, and did it feel like he got back to his old self today?
Listen, this game of basketball, sometimes you're going to go through a little slump, but you're going to get back up. Your teammates are going to pick you up, and you just got to continue to grind. That kid works every single day. He comes in, he puts in the work. So we knew it was going to be a matter of time. As long as he plays hard defensively, everything else really doesn't matter offensively. He'll come back. He'll make sure to play the game that he was playing before.
You guys have been very good on the road this season. In your mind, how is that the case that whenever there's a road game, you guys seem to come together and play so effectively?
I wish I had the answer. I think, you know, guys are playing every night. You know, they're not taking a night off. At home, they're playing just as hard. You know, it's one or two possessions away from winning the game at home. So tonight it could have been the same thing. You know, it was one possession game. We ended up making the last shot. So guys continue to play hard, continue to play the way we want them to play defensively. And I think at the end it pays off.
Coach, as always, thank you so much for your time and a big congratulations.
Thank you, guys.
We'll see you soon, as always. And that's assistant coach Ronald Ramon following the 67-65 victory for your Fordham Rams on the road in St. Louis. And Colin, this was fun from the get-go. Lots of energy in this gym. And of course, the Elijah Gray fadeaway. That's one I'm never going to forget.
I don't know if I've ever seen him hit it before, but I'm certainly happy for him that he hit it there. It's so important for young players, freshmen, sophomores, to have those moments where they can flex their confidence. And to see Elijah Gray show that bit of confidence, certainly impressive for a player as young as he is. Fordham still with a lot of work to do going forward, but this win over St. Louis, certainly a step in the right direction, Miles.
So 67-65, your final score from St. Louis, Missouri. He's been Colin Loughran. I've been Miles Grossman, saying thank you so much for spending part of your Saturday with us. A career high for Kyle Rose, 26 points. And the Fordham Rams pick up the victory. They now move to 10-12 on the year. 4-5 here in Atlantic 10 play. But that's going to do it for Colin and I. A big win for the Fordham Rams on the road. And with that, we'll send it back to our Rose Hill studios for a post-game show with Owen Kelty and Michael Matuch.
The one-on-one post-game report.
Welcome into the one-on-one post-game show. Once again, I'm Owen Kelty, joined by Michael Matuch. The Fordham Rams win this one 67-65. With sophomore Elijah Gray cashing in on the fadeaway game-winning shot. I mean, what an incredible game that we just were able to witness, listen to. I don't even know where to start. Just give me your thoughts overall on what we just saw.
We won a game in St. Louis. Thank God.
Ending the streak. 9-year streak.
Oh, man. I'm happy with the win, but that second half was a bit shaky. Win's a win. I'm going to take it any day of the week. A little bit shaky in the second half.
Always going to take a win on the road, and like you said, that second half was very shaky, getting outscored 33-26, coming in with a 9-point lead at the half, ending up having to hit a fadeaway game winner to win this game 67-65. We were talking about this before. Not often do you win a game where you don't score a field goal in the last 4 minutes, getting outscored. I believe St. Louis went on an 8-0 run with the last 3 minutes of the game, but like we talked about in the first half, what ended up coming through was their defense.
Yeah, the defense really stepped up. And just being able to lock down, I feel like if without that, this game would have been worse and we would have lost. It would have been bad.
Yeah, without the defense, finishing with 14 steals on the game and forcing 18 turnovers, that's what kept them in this game. In the second half, they really didn't have much going offensively. Really not a lot of guys in the lineup besides Kyle Rose had it going offensively. Leading scorer for Fordham, 26 points on 9 of 15, shooting 4 of 9 from 3. But otherwise, besides him, a couple of rough shooting days. Jaffe Madore, 1 of 6 from the field. Will Richardson, 1 of 9. But in the end, does it really matter how anyone shot?
Doesn't
when you can
matter.
Hit a game winner,
doesn't matter.
Win your first game in St. Louis in 9 times, it's just an incredible game.
What a ballsy move by Ergo to get Elijah Gray the ball there at the end. That was nuts. That was sick.
I mean, like Colin said, like having a big man back him down and with 2 seconds left, being able to pull up a shot, a fadeaway, and being able to cash it in, and then leaving no time on the clock really for St. Louis to do anything after that, it's really incredible, and it's a great win for this team.
It is.
Going forward.
That was his first made shot of this half.
going into that, up to before he took that shot, he was 3 for 9 on the night. And to see coach really believe in his guys like that is inspiring.
Especially a guy like Elijah Gray, sophomore, who's been having a really good season this year. And out of a young player, you're going to expect those ups and downs. But being able to trust him and know what he's given you all year and being able to put the ball in his hands, game on the line, especially when St. Louis was probably expecting to go to Kyle Rose, who had been dominating them the whole game, going to a guy you know you can trust and him coming through like that is huge for the team.
It really is. Owen, a big part of this second half that I really saw a struggle, we talked about this in the half, is we started taking a lot of three shots that we just weren't simply making.
Yeah. I mean, coming into the half, they shot, they were 6 of 18 from three. They finished the game 8 of 29 from three.
Yeah.
So really what we talked about was what was going to get St. Louis back in this game was going out there and chucking up threes. And it kind of seems like shooting 28% from three, and that's really what let them get back into this game and eventually led to it being such a close one down the end, Fordham trailing. They ended up, what had been part of their downfall all year, though, was missed free throws, and in the end, they hit a couple of big free throws to keep this game close, keep it tied. 82% from the line, always what you need for a win.
If we really didn't improve on our free throws shooting at the beginning of the year, this game, we would have lost because of those free throws. Mm-hmm. And seeing us come in and hit from the charity stripe is big. But when you shoot 18% from the three line in the second half, it's not usually a recipe for success, but I'm happy we did.
Yeah, when you're on the road and you're shooting so poorly, 38% from the field, 28% from three, being able to come out with a win like this, and such a, the second half wasn't great, but being able to leave on such a high note of a game-winning shot really just propels, I think will propel them forward the rest of the year. This is momentum for not only the next game, but for the whole year, because you know you can go to him down the stretch and trust him. And they showed grit and toughness, that you blow a lead, you blow a 9-point lead, you're kind of dominating that whole game. You had time, led the game for 34 minutes to 2 minutes. But at the end of the game there, it felt like this game could have slipped away, and being able to pull out that win is something that's huge for this program.
There have been a few games where we had the game just slip through our fingers right in the last few minutes, and we didn't do that. We didn't let it happen. We stopped it. The most important part of this game was when there was 10 seconds left and we were inbounding the ball to Elijah Gray. He has his dribble, his shot, and it sinks. I was so impressed with that final play, being able to really come together as a unit when it really mattered most.
Yeah, another huge win for Fordham, looking to get back on track. But that is going to be all from us here in the Rose Hill Studios. Once again, Fordham wins 67-65. On the call was Miles Grossman and Colin Loughran. Griffin Stevenson had you with all the highlights. Gabby Price, the engineer. And behind the glass, the great Brian Rabax. Sports director of WFUV Sports is Bobby Chaffardini. For Michael Matuch, I'm Owen Kelty. Have a great rest of your day. Fordham basketball is a product of WFUV Sports.